Ladies and gentlemen, now the moment you've all been waiting for.
You are now listening to the sounds of the
Milkcrates and Microphones.
What does it do? What's it for? Well, nothing. I mean, nothing.
Don't stay too fucking long, man. We got a lot of work to do.
Don't worry. Catch you on the flip side.
Load the spaceship with the rocket fuel.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing.
You really think you can fly that thing?
You really think you can do all that bullshit you just said?
3, 2, 1.
And here we go again, another podcast on another Friday night. It is that Milk Crates and motherfucking Microphones, and I am your host, Mr. B Sick Wonder Eye, Mr. Brandon F. on Fry, and with me as always is your boy, his boy, their boy, everybody's boy, Soldier's boy, plus the Suicide Boys, and I'm having trouble talking in this motherfucking mask, but I'm gonna get it out like this. You know who it is, it's your host with the most, who is you?
What's good? It's your boy, the Infamous Nonsense. It's Friday night, December, getting them Christmas vibes. Things are coming together just right. So I appreciate being here tonight, and I appreciate all you motherfuckers for making this happen. So, man, let's get that motherfucker started.
And we're coming back with our episode 12 of this series. We had Oscar Goldman on last week, or the podcast before this, and we got some big names coming in the future. But before we get to our guest tonight, I'm going to introduce the man to the left. He's not on the right. He used to be a JS3 from now to infinity, but he'll be known as...
JS motherfucking 3.
Yo.
Triple Sig.
You son of a bitch.
Sig.
Formerly
it's
known as...
It's the mask.
Yo. What is good? What is good? It's Friday. I'm feeling good, and I'm fucking excited.
Yes.
If you haven't heard the new Oscar Goldman self-titled album... You better wake up from that nap.
Oscar Goldman's new album.
Tell them where you're going tonight.
I'm going to go see that man live. Album release party, baby. Oscar Goldman.
There you go.
Tonight.
You heard it here first.
Hell yeah.
You're good.
And joining us for another edition of this podcast is another
alumni.
Alumni. Someone that's been on the podcast plenty of times before. You know who he is. It's Mr. Real Life.
What's
crack? Yo.
Thank you for having me again. Always a good time.
Of course.
Mask off. Jesus.
I can breathe.
Yo.
Holy shit.
Give my man a letter, because he's on the varsity team, dog. This guy's an alumni right here.
Thank you.
I don't know how many times he's been on.
No more lock doors.
A million and a half.
Okay, we back. Hey, and Steve's back with us on the motherfucking podcast. We're going to have a good time tonight. We're going to talk a little bit about everything that's going on in pop culture history. And if you ever came to anywhere, if you ever came anywhere for great political talk and pop culture history, then you came to the right place.
Yeah, the right place.
We're the smartest motherfuckers. As one person commented on our YouTube page, there's not one brain cell left
combined,
in this room.
Combined two brain cells in this room, they said. So.
Well, I don't think there's any left, so we're going to prove that.
We're running on fumes.
Stick with us tonight, and we might be able to prove that to you.
Yes, sir.
But before we get to any of that stupid shit, we got to do what we always do. And we do something that we do every week, and it is this week in motherfucking hip hop.
Caught me off guard.
You got something for us, or no?
Of course. Coming at you, motherfucking, this week.
We lost all cameras.
No way. Really?
Yeah. All cameras down.
All right. We're still recording, though.
We're still good. We got it.
We got one at least?
No, we're still recording, though.
You don't have one.
We're good.
It's all right. Coming at you this motherfucking weekend.
Keep it going.
December 3rd, 1996. How many years ago was that? That's 26 years ago.
Yeah.
26 years ago, Triple Six Mafia released their motherfucking album. You know what it was called. Chapter 1, The End. Conforming of the group, you got your boys over here. You know who they are. The three motherfuckers. You got Juicy J, DJ Paul, and who's that?
Hold on. No. Who were a part of that album? It was not only Juicy J.
Oh, no. There's hella fools. It's DJ Paul, Koopsta, Nicka, Crunchy Black, Lord Famous, and Gangsta Boo.
People think the 3-6 Mafia or DJ Paul.
No, there's a lot of people on that album.
That is the 3-6 Mafia of today.
Yes. But the original 3-6 Mafia, there was like six fools in it.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Hence the word Mafia.
Yeah. So off of the motherfucking album, I don't know what to do. Either I'm going to do good stuff or in too deep. Maybe even Last Man Standing.
There's a lot of good hits on that.
There's a lot of good hits. I think we should do Give Me Maybe Good Stuff. Maybe Ooh. Even I Ain't Going.
Maybe you should give me something else.
You don't want any of those, huh?
I'm not saying I don't.
The late night tip, maybe late night tip.
That's a classic too. I'll do the. You know what's crazy? It's hard to find the late night tip version that's not edited.
Yes,
you can only find the edited version.
I think this one will be edited too.
Even on the album, that's an explicit album parental advisory sticker. The late night tip is still edited. I don't understand
it's probably
why.
Because they recorded it and somebody edited it, and they were like, "Well, you edited the only one we had. That was the only one, and that was it."
Maybe. It was a big hit. They had like a music video for
somebody
it.
Fucked up, man. They didn't dub it. They just had one. Homie's like a hella high in the studio. Just did the quick dub on the first one. He's like, "Wait a minute, did you just dub the original?" He's like, "What you mean? That's the only one we had." Maybe that's how it happened. Could be the story. I could see it happening like that. Couldn't you?
Yeah, I mean, I could see that. Edited 3-6 Mafia is not my favorite 3-6 Mafia.
No, but maybe this one won't be edited. Maybe the man will find Late Night Tip not edited.
I mean, you got to dig.
You got to dig. Let's go ahead and get that
you
going.
You
got
to dig deep.
All this right. is your boy, 3-6 Mafia, coming in with Late Night Tip. This is with Lord Infamous, Gangsta Boo, DJ Paul, Juicy J, and Koopstanica.
Hell yeah.
So if you ain't fucking listening to this album, I think you should go pick it up. It's pretty badass. You know what I mean? Chapter 1, then, you know, it's pretty sick.
Yeah, today, 1 year ago, 3-6 battled Bone Thugs for the Triller versus fucking
I ain't gonna have you ugly motherfucker.
And they almost threw down.
They were doing it, bro. They came at
Busy Apple. Bone was talking shit to 3-6. I think he threw a water bottle at him too.
That's the reason. That's the reason why I wasn't gonna go Bone Thugs, because we've done Bone Thugs a few times. So I'm gonna go Trip 6.
Bone Thugs got some mouths, but I think 3-6 got some hands.
Yeah, straight. 3-6 was ready though. Hands they came right at that fool, and then he saw Busy like pushing fools like to go fight them for him. Like, what do? You talk all that shit, then you push fools to fight for you.
All right, here we go. This is 3-6 Mafia
Late Night Tip
with the unedited version right off the album of Late Night Tip.
Hold on, let's see. Edited version.
All right, that was 3-6 Mafia with Late Night Tip. Thought it was unedited. Straight off the album.
Still hard as fuck.
Six said, fuck you.
That beat is hard.
You think when he was? How do you think he even got that style of beats? I mean, that beat. Suicide Boys became famous from these guys.
I was thinking the whole time, what made you think that Suicide Boys was just like, oh, fucking, I'm going to rob these fools right now.
They're
this beat
smart.
Right now.
Super smart, bro, to just be like, we could just rob everything they've done and we could just make it.
They didn't really
music.
Rob everything they
did. They sampled the shit.
They just sampled the beat.
How about this? When I was at the show, they said in the beginning, I can't do any of the old songs because we're being fucking in the middle of a lawsuit right now. They couldn't play any old songs.
Of course. Why wouldn't 3-6, first of all, do you stamp 3-6 Mafia Late Night Tip?
I stamped their shit.
I'm not stamping it.
You don't
I think
like
it's
it?
Whack.
It's not bad. Whoa. Actually, the only reason why I give them so much respect is because I have so much love for the boys. I love the Boys a lot.
I think my Boys did it better.
Yeah, for sure. The Boys always do it better.
Whoa.
I think the Boys did it better.
Get but the hell out of here.
I think they knew what they
garbage.
Were doing. When you steal from someone like that, you steal and you're like, hey, I'm looking to get in trouble. Just like, you know, like we want to. I would love to just rob somebody blindly for their stuff and then do it better than they do. And then you get the publicity for it. And then you get busted.
You would love that?
Yeah, because when you finally get
sound
busted.
Sound like a real dirtbag.
I mean, when you finally get busted, that means you're making some noise, correct? I mean, some people are hearing your shit.
Sure?
Some people are finally hearing
your shit. Yeah, for sure. You know, I mean, you're catching on.
Yeah, so I give them all the respect because they walk so the Suicide Boys could run.
Oh man, hold on. I think
you know what I mean.
These men have been running.
These men have been running. Don't get me wrong.
Suicide Boys are.
How about this? Suicide Boys jogging, ran. Jogging Suicide Boys side. Ran because of them.
These fools. These fools ran a 400, so Suicide can run an 800.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
I mean, I don't think
they
a lot of,
ran.
I don't
so
think
they can run further.
Yeah.
They ran so they can run further. Yeah, I give it that.
Suicide Boys have a big following, okay?
The hugest.
But not nearly as big as the 3-6 Mafia.
Right? I'm just saying.
Bro,
yeah.
These
I'm
guys are world,
I don't know, dude.
World known.
I don't know. So are the Boys.
Maybe
the Boys are pretty well
the
known.
The Boys
nowadays.
Are world known.
Not worldwide. Yeah. Probably a handful of countries, though.
Yeah, worldwide. For sure.
So maybe some Eastern European countries.
Yeah.
Bro, you know, some of those ghetto ones.
Worldwide.
Milkcrates and Microphones is worldwide.
Yeah,
you think fucking Suicide Boys isn't worldwide?
Yeah, but not every country.
We're worldwide. We're everywhere, too.
We were in like 60 countries.
Yeah.
Are there 60 countries?
Yeah.
Is there? Or is this a trick question? Do you know?
How many countries are
there? You are showing the brain
got
cells
me.
In the room.
I don't
you
know,
son
man.
Of a bitch.
I don't know.
You're supposed to be on our team.
Oh, shit.
See?
Way more than that.
Let me guess.
And I'm not a good geography guy.
230.
Nope. We're not going to say it.
More?
Just give me more or less. There's more than 60.
More than 230?
Way more than 60.
More than 200?
No.
Okay. That's good enough for me.
Right below.
That's good enough
for
me.
Yeah.
I'll give it 137.
195, but we cool.
Pretty close. That's close.
Listen, we're not dumb.
No, we're not.
We're not
geography majors. Though.
We're just not geography majors or
mathematicians.
We're not math missions and
yeah,
missions.
Geometry majors.
I know my ABCs, my 1-2-3s.
I know my left to rights and ups to downs.
Yeah.
All right, what do you guys been up to? What do you guys been watching? What's going on? You got nothing new for you guys? Same old shit.
Lately, I've been
not doing shit.
No,
listening to no new music.
No, I listen to
what
new music. I just listened to the whole new Oscar Goldman album. Can you say that?
Jesus.
Can you say that, you
Christ.
Son of a bitch?
I've guess been listening
what?
To
that. I didn't even know
it
was you. You got a mask day. On. You didn't know think you got a mask on.
I was
on.
Working all day, so how was I supposed to listen to Oscar
at work?
Because
I know you fucking listen to music the whole
no,
day.
I
or podcast.
I can't.
There's no podcast
with
work.
People. No, I was listening to nothing today. I was interactions. Mm. Interacting with people.
What about
all
when you
day.
Golfed? You couldn't put it on?
No, you got to have a fucking silence.
You son of
it's
got to
be silence. You know you can't have people fucking rapping and talking while you're
we play music the whole time we play.
You son of a bitch, dude. You shut the fuck up.
Sorry,
now.
Sorry. Here we go.
What you have been listening to
so
lately?
How, what you, so let's talk about it. Oscar Goldman's. We had Oscar Goldman in last time. He just dropped. Today was his release, and he's actually having his album release party. Mm-hmm. For
so he's on his way there tonight.
Self-titled album, Oscar Goldman, with the beautiful pink guillotine on the front.
Yep. Hell yeah.
Tell me a little bit about this album. I listened to a few tracks. We got to see a sneak peek of the new video before it dropped yesterday.
Yeah.
The beats are tight, dude. The beats.
Tell me about the album. How do you feel about it production-wise? How great. We know we love Oscar. We love his music and his rapping style, but what do you think about the production? Because I think that's really
the
what...
Beats, the beats are tight, dude. I'm not going to lie. The beats the beats are good. They remind
the
me...
The dude that did the produced it, the Casey Chisholm dude, he's dope.
Yeah, Casey
Chisholm. I like his style. He's got like that kind of like a... an oddball kind of sound, like if you would put it like
good.
That.
Yeah. Something that's just like not normal.
You don't hear it all the time, but you do hear it. You hear it on like that girl Mars Argo kind of has those kind of beats, and kind of like
bro,
just
that
like,
was what was
like
beautiful
underground
about music.
Style. Yeah,
back in the day, that everyone was doing their own thing, right? Making their own sound. Everyone had their own sound, so you can like differentiate between artists and producers.
Yeah.
Oh, that's this full sound. Oh, that's fucking Factor. Or, oh, that right there is fucking
he has a
Premier.
Sound.
Casey
or,
has a sound.
Yeah, he's
Casey
got a
Chisholm.
Sound. Yeah, he's got a sound. That's
what's beautiful because nowadays a lot of rappers and producers, they all just try to mimic each other and do what they're doing but do it a little bit better. And so everyone ends up sounding the same.
For sure.
Like on
and there's like, we don't, I don't know the
biters.
On his Instagram.
Oh, Jesus.
Biting.
On his Instagram, he has this song where he's skateboarding through his street. You seen it, right?
Yeah.
That fucking song is hard, dude.
For sure.
That beat's hard. The whole thing's tight as fuck, dude. I give him props. Like the whole thing's just it's different. It's what you're kind excited looking for when you're not looking for it?
Say, you excited? What are you most excited to see perform?
So I'm super excited to see Oscar, you know, fucking obviously. But Casey Chisholm is going to be there in person.
Oh, wow. Doing beats and shit?
Yeah, with the production live and hitting the turntables.
You're going to hit a little interview on the
maybe
iPhone?
Maybe it's a laptop. I don't know. Either way, I don't give a fuck.
You can catch some words on the iPhone interview?
Oh, for sure. I mean, I'm going to catch a little something at least.
You know what I've been seeing fools do on the iPhone? They take one of these and they wrap it on the bottom of the iPhone. It looks like a mic.
Really?
Yeah.
I've never seen that.
I've seen it. And it sounds good. The spit guard over your thing so no one's like spitting on your phone and shit. Yeah. So they put the thing over it. And then once they have it on there, they just go.
Show them. Put it on.
Give me one.
Right there. All right.
Here.
You got one right there.
That's something, huh? Please. Are you sure it's not like a special one they're making for iPhones?
They grab it and they put it over the iPhone like this.
And he's putting it on his iPhone right now. It's just a spit guard.
Just a spit guard.
Across the iPhone.
Across the whole bottom like that.
Yeah. Okay.
And then once it's on there properly, when I get if I put it on there properly, I would do it.
Damn, now you're Mean Gene. Mean Gene.
Yeah, like, so tell me how it was. How was your show tonight?
Here, record something. Let's hear it.
Boom.
Let's rehear
it. Let's do it.
Let's hear it. Let's record something.
All right.
We're gonna record something with the mic. Yeah, we're gonna do a real in the room test.
Fucking myth busting.
He's already myth busting his own myth. He ripped it.
Good God.
I think people are buying special ones.
No, they're not.
Well, they're not ripping like that when they try to take them on and off.
This is also 100 years old, sitting on a rusty old mic. Over
hey, don't be talking.
We got a whole fucking sack full of them.
So. Nonsense about our microphones. These are classic mics.
We got a whole fucking sack full of them.
Classic microphone.
All right, here we go. Hold on. You ready?
Let's hear it.
Yeah, right. For sure. Definitely ready.
We're going to do a little interview for you.
Always ready.
Yo, we're here live tonight with your boy, Realize. I just want to know, how'd you feel about tonight's show? I mean, do you feel like you performed your best or do you think it could have been better?
I think you're a son of a bitch. And
a real cocksucker.
Any of your podcast views, and I want nothing to do with you guys.
He said it and he heard it first. Steven here says he loves the show. He loves being on it, and everything he says is totally approvable for Milkcrates Microphones. So where do you think you're going to be performing next?
Fuck you.
He said
okay, let's hear it now. Let's hear it now. Let's hear it now.
Play it back. This is like the talk back. Remember the talk back?
All right, here we go.
Or talk boy. Talk boy.
Sounds hella good.
Hold on.
Sounds good, dude. Sounds really good.
Do you think it would sound any worse without the sleeve on it?
Try it now.
It's not that it doesn't sound worse.
No, try it with the sleeve.
We don't need a fucking
spitting all over your phone.
Try the sleeve. Try without the sleeve. Let's go without sleeve. Just try it.
Nah.
Fuck the
sleeve.
We already got the proven facts. The proven facts are there.
I'll interview Sig.
I got it. I'm gonna give you another interview.
Let's do without the sleeve. How do you do? You can't do what do they call that experiment? A science experiment. It's called a double. No, double entendre is not a science. Here we go again. We're not going to talk about
double.
This.
Yeah. You're making us look foolish again. Here we go. Hold on.
Double blind placebo. I just made us look smart. That's a science experiment. And whenever you do a science project, you have to test one way, both ways, so you can get an actual fucking test.
Right,
double blind.
What is that called?
Double blind placebo.
No. What is it called when you get the? It's called the law.
The law.
No, it's called a law. Like when science has something and it's a for sure and it's just how it is. Every time you do it, it becomes a law.
Double blind placebo.
All right. So
you're right? Placebo.
I mean, you're kind of right, but kind of, I mean.
Huh? I think we're in something. I think I was in something.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm spitting facts out
here. We're going to go without it now.
All right,
hold on. I'm spitting facts out here, son. Go ahead.
Schooling people tonight. Proving that he's not dumb.
So, in a short 30-second little clip, I've seen you on stage. You're doing really great. I mean, everything you do for the community is perfect. In 30 seconds, can you give us what hip-hop means to you?
What it means?
Just tell him, fuck you.
Damn. I don't know. Hip hop means a lot.
That's a lot, dude. That was deep.
That was deep.
Yeah. That was hard.
Deep. There we are. Here we are with
that. Hey, well said. Well said.
Appreciate you.
Thank
you.
Hey, look at you.
All right, here we go. You ready?
Great job, Steve. Great job. Great interview. Sounds way worse.
Sounds way worse. Sometimes you need the spit guard.
Yeah, it sounds way worse.
Give Sig a spit guard tonight.
Sig, you're going home with a spit guard. Yep. You're getting an interview with Casey Chisholm.
If you do,
on point.
Casey Chisholm interview. A small one would be pretty sick, and you do it with a little thingy on you, you'd be legit.
Speaking of interviews, we got to go there. What's up with Kanye West lately and his interviews?
I'll be right back.
I actually feel
Kanye West is just doing his thing, man.
Hold on, we're doing his thing.
I've been telling you for a long time.
I'm confused.
For the last couple of years, I think Kanye sucks. Number one, he's got some good music here and there. You know, I like a few of his songs. Don't get me wrong. I want the old Kanye back. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah. But I'm saying Kanye sucks for a long time. 15 years?
So the man himself is now not doubled, not tripled, not quadrupled. He just went, he just said down, down, down. No one has to say.
Has the man snapped?
No. I mean,
or is he being like sarcastic, just trying to piss people off?
I don't
know. What's going on with this?
They're trying to also say.
Is he playing the heel?
I don't. I mean, he's definitely a heel.
You know what he said?
But this is the ultimate heel.
He said that wasn't even him on the fucking Alex Jones show. How about that?
Hold on.
For a
no.
Yes.
He did not say that.
Yes, he did.
I didn't hear that.
He did it, and he threw everybody off. Stop. He threw everybody off at the camp.
I've heard other people say that.
Are you trying to say they cloned him? It kind of doesn't sound like him.
It sounds like him.
Lightweight. Not like a bunch.
It sounds like him with a... He's wearing a sex slave mask. Wouldn't you have the sex slave mask?
And it's a Balenciaga mask after he decided to say, fuck Balenciaga, he's wearing the mask.
Did he say that?
Yes. No, he didn't. They looked it up. I saw the mask, and they have a picture of it in the catalog from Balenciaga. The same.
And listen, listen, listen. This is a podcast of a lot of facts. If we don't say facts, the people are going to be mad at us. So
yeah. How about this?
Don't be spitting fake news like you usually do.
No, this is real.
And tell only facts.
Fuck this fake is real. News.
So what he was saying on the fucking show, we all know,
I'm for the people on YouTube.
Hitler legitimately did a lot of bad things, but he also did some good things for him as he looks at it.
Mm-hmm. And he also says he likes Hitler and he likes Nazis.
Did he say he likes Nazis?
Yes.
Did he say that?
Yes.
He said that?
If you watch the clips that I sent, yes.
I watched the clips and I sent you some things too back, but he's just straight says, he goes, well, if the man created the microphone, the thing that I make my money off of, the thing that we're using right now, I mean,
that's one
he did some good things. Just he did some good things then, right?
Clip.
That's what he's saying.
And then the other one's like,
I don't agree with the man at all.
The other one, Alex Jones is like, ah, no, we can't say that. Or I don't agree with that stuff, blah, blah, blah. And all of a sudden Kanye goes, I like Hitler.
Oh no!
Yeah,
this is coming from This is coming from the man who also said Sandy Hook was a fake. This son of a bitch.
Well, that's Alex Jones.
Yes,
and even look, Kanye next to Alex Jones. Alex Jones is even like
Alex Jones looking like a god. Alex Jones looking like a god.
Because this, you know, like even Alex Jones is not agreeing.
Can we play
this
clip?
You know?
Can we play this clip?
That's like the story I heard about when Jim Carrey was doing the Man on the Moon role. He was doing the Andy Kaufman, and he was just stuck in that role.
Uh-huh.
And
oh,
Jim Carrey was talking about how he was sitting down, and his best friend at the time was Nicolas Cage, and he was having lunch with Nicolas Cage, and he was just off his rocker, you know, Jim Carrey just at his worst.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And
I heard he got stuck on that character for a long time.
Yeah, and so he's sitting here having lunch with Nick Cage, and Nick Cage stops in the middle of lunch, gives up, and goes, sorry, Jim. I just can't take it, man. You're just losing it, and you're scaring me. I got to go.
No way.
And he leaves, and Jim Carrey said that was rock bottom because he thought, man, when you can weird out Nick Cage, you're really on some weird shit because Nick Cage is
a weirdo
motherfucker.
Yeah, weird.
So do you think
Kanye
is
like
Kanye, stuck in a character?
Kanye looking saying? Like more of a dirtbag than Alec Jones. Like, I mean, when you stand next to one of the biggest dirtbags in the world.
I think he's doubling
Alex Jones
down.
Isn't a dirtbag. I shouldn't say that. He's just a...
I think
dummy,
he doubled down. I think he doubled down.
He said stuff that turned out to be not true. And then that's basically...
He said a lot of things that has turned out to be not true. Like when
I don't know how much...
Back
how
in
much,
the day,
he
I
definitely
remember
said some stuff
a clip in like 2005 that was going around of that fool had like aerial footage of these farms. And it looked like they looked like biodegradable caskets, right?
Yes.
Stacked up in rows and rows and rows.
FEMA
and he was like,
FEMA camp.
Yes, caskets. He kept saying they're FEMA camp caskets.
Well,
they weren't, though. They were like some agriculture shit. And he was telling everyone that they're FEMA
that,
camp.
Honestly, I'm gonna sit here and say, I'm pretty sure those were caskets.
Can we play
for
the
who?
Clip?
For what?
For
what
happened?
For who?
What are you getting
if
out of
look,
this?
If you look into it, in case a tragedy ever hits and FEMA just ready to get rid of like bodies that are everywhere, for instance, COVID, pandemics, people dying everywhere.
Can we play the clip? Can we play a little Kanye clip? Just a little bit of I want the people to hear what we're talking about.
I think they've already heard it, dude.
Have they?
Millions of views. Millions
have they heard it? Has everybody heard it?
I'm sure people have heard it.
Do we want to like promote that?
No, we don't
want to respond.
Hold on, we're not promoting it
at all. We're not promoting it. We're downgrading
but we're playing it.
Right.
We're still giving it light.
Don't give it any light.
We don't need to play it.
I say, you know what we want to give light
to? It's just insane.
What do you got?
Let's play Oscar Goldman's new music video that just dropped.
Which one? Devolve?
Yep.
Play that one. That one's pretty tight.
This music video just dropped yesterday, if I'm not.
And it already has 1.5 million.
At least a million
views.
Five.
At least 1.5 million views. Pretty fucking crazy.
That's amazing.
Isn't it crazy all that fool is in the interview and they're like, I love your style. I love the way you dress. I love your music. I love your paintings. Where do you get all your style from? And he goes, Rob Zombie.
All across the board.
Rob Zombie. And, oh, yeah, my favorite rapper is Oscar Goldman.
Yeah.
Best rapper in California. Hell clips yeah. like that are make a fucking album what I like.
Hell yeah.
I like a good little, like I said, a good, the Aesop one.
Well, yeah,
this Aesop Rock, I just want to let you know that Oscar Goldman sucks.
Yeah.
That's hard as fuck.
That's so
dude.
Dope.
I like that a lot. Made me smile. Made me smile.
Here we go. We're going to give a shout out to our boy. Congratulations on your beautiful album. Thank you so much for all the love you send us. Oscar Goldman, MCMP stamps this shit. This is Oscar Goldman's new music video. You can go check it out on YouTube under the Oscar Goldman page. That's OSCAR Goldman. You know how to spell that shit.
Hell,
this
yeah.
song is called Devolve.
So dope.
Oscar is a dummy thinking everyone's the same. We all ambled around town with skin and a brain. Living in the days when he had to smell trash. His nose knows best, it's all he'll ever have. Inside a cubicle, computer screens and nomads. Who's to follow dreams if it's stuck inside a notepad? 2020 have him shook up when he rock a crowd. Next he would have had a better chance with forks in an outlet or a knife in the toaster. Being that card that you disregard, I am the Joker. Overtime, never paid as much as he wished.
It looks like he'd be named Joker right there, huh?
Yeah.
In the days when people gave it their all, there was nothing more to be than anything that evolved.
I'm appalled.
Don't get involved. Never really cared about anything more than happiness, whether it's for myself or for others to be attached to it.
It's an acid trip.
We lost them, huh?
Class dismissed. In the days when people gave it their all, there was nothing more to be than anything that evolved.
I'm appalled.
Don't get involved. Catch him riding shoddy on his way to the SP. Resembles guillotines with the way he stays ahead of me. Remembering is everything, letting go and measuring. Crediting myself with the scrambled eggs recipe. Get back, Mac, the quack attack is back. Flip knuckle, puck the top of your cap for a hat trick. Classic, don't get caught, we do magic and disappear every time I'm given the advantage. Back in the days when people gave it their all, there was nothing more to be than anything that evolved.
I'm appalled.
Don't get involved. Never really cared about anything more than happiness, whether it's for myself or for others to be attached to it.
It's an acid trip.
Class dismissed. Back in the days when people gave it their all, there was nothing more to be than anything that evolved. I'm appalled. Don't get involved. Stuck in the Titanic, we panic and try to break out. Face facts, probably the last moment in the safe house. Oh well, what am I to do but fade away? Try to live with no regrets and be a part of Labor Days. Did they get that reference?
No.
All good, I'll try to stay basic. Thumbs up, Fonzie, running from paparazzi. Roger Klotz, I stay green in the lobby. Doggy bag, eating off the promised land.
Copy that.
Gotta make a meal off of all of that.
So dope. The Fonz. That's the fucking Fonz of the future right there.
Bro, you're telling me.
Hell yeah, bro. Shout out to Oscar Goldman. Please go cop that album.
Shout out to my boy over here. My boy over here is working hard behind the scenes. You have no idea. He's working hard behind the scenes.
It's a dope album, man. Fake Four, fucking, hey. They have some good artists for sure.
He's a bad motherfucker.
I'm glad Oscar's a part of Fake Four.
I'm going to have to go ahead and say that that's a bad dude right there. And, you're an even badder dude for going tonight. Right after this, you're shooting out that way. You're a good guy, man.
Hell yeah, bro. Yeah, fucking A, man. I saw the big shout-out from Chesky earlier to Oscar and just all the good words he had to say about the man. And just, you know,
yeah,
I'm very proud of the guy, man. It's fucking badass, bro.
It's cool that he's been on the show so many times, too. He's like I said, he's a normal guy around here. He's like a guy with the green jacket on. You know, you'd see him on the course. You're like, hey, that's him, you know.
For sure.
You know, he's a nice guy.
Another new album that that recently dropped that I've been listening to, at least. Vinnie Paz dropped a new album.
I seen that.
Yeah, what do you... What do you think about Vinnie Paz?
Do you see the new music video?
I love Vinnie Paz.
Do you like Vinnie Paz on his own?
Yeah. I like his
style. He's been by himself for a while.
For a minute. I feel like his style it's kind of changed a little bit, though.
A little bit. Maybe it will explain.
I feel like he's not so, I don't know how to say it, but not so, so deep into, this.
Philosophical
type
of stuff.
Yeah, he's not preaching secrets anymore and, look deeper into something. He's more, just kind of rapping now, you know?
kind of, sort of. It's like some heavy, hard-hitting raps, I guess, and like maybe some violent type of rhymes or whatever.
How much new stuff, though, has he come out with? Like
a whole album?
Before this album? Like, what was the last album he put out? Because like, I've listened to his shit, but I don't know, like...
He had a couple singles, I feel like. Yeah. Just a couple pop-out singles here and there.
Like, when I try to think of a
song... Oh, man, he's got... okay, so... Shit, 2021, he had an album.
Okay, so
2020, 2018, 2016, 2012,
yeah, I guess we're all
2010.
Wrong. I guess we're all wrong.
This man has been dropping just tons of albums, I'm telling you.
How do you feel about it, though? Like, you got a favorite or a favorite song lately?
Yeah, I mean, off that album, shout out to Method Man, who's on track number two, Silent Ether, I want to say it's called.
How's the beat?
Vinny Paz and Method Man on the same track?
That's pretty sick, dude.
Hell yeah. Vinny Paz is... pretty fucking known now. He's been on Joe Rogan.
Yes, he has been on Rogan.
Like, Rogan's a fan of Paz.
I
hear other podcasts talking about Vinny Paz too. But Jedi Mind Tricks, man, I've been into that group for a long time.
It's kind of crazy to think that he came on there and Rogan likes JMT.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's crazy to think.
For sure.
It's DMT, fucking JMT, fucking, you know, all of it, man.
Another podcast, Keeping It 100 with Conan. He's a fan of Vinny Paz, and they're boys, and it's pretty tight.
During
the wrestling, yeah.
Okay.
During the former NWO member.
For some reason, when you said Conan, I thought the late night show host.
No. He might know him, too, though. I feel like Vinny Paz has been on some late night shows performing.
I feel like if you go on Rogan, you get the Rogan push. Right off the bat, you get the push. People start looking for you. They want to know what you're doing.
To get onto Rogan,
it's a platform.
You can't be really a nobody.
Or you just got to be, Rogan's got to be your fan. Rogan's got to be a fan of you.
Kind of made it if you got on there.
Yeah, I mean, he probably invited him on. Yeah. I think that's what Rogan does now. He reaches out to guests because he can have whoever he wants, really.
Yeah, you
so
don't
he,
ask.
He especially reaches out to whoever he would like to have on. And
he picks what he's interested in.
Pretty much.
The crazy thing is, I haven't listened to Rogan in a few months now. I just can't get into podcasts lately anymore. I don't know what it is. It's just, I just can't stand to hear someone talk for that long. Maybe because we've been doing this for so many years now. That it's just so hard for me to sit down and hear somebody else talk about something, you know?
Yeah. Are you into podcasts at all?
Yeah.
Realize?
I go back and forth.
Who do you listen to?
Well, obviously the three main ones, the Nelk, Impulsive, and fucking Rogan. Mm-hmm. I hate all those three. And
Impulsive's dope as fuck.
Who's Impulsive?
What's his name? Joe Rogan's buddy.
Logan Paul.
Oh, Logan Paul. So Logan Paul?
Jake Paul's brother.
Really?
Yeah. Impulsive.
Yeah. No.
Tyson went on there and was eating shrooms.
Theo Vaughn's are pretty good.
Theo Vaughn's are funny. Those are funny.
He's fine.
No Jumper sometimes. I'll fuck with that.
That joke is cool.
There was a fight that went down on Jumper recently.
Was that real or was that fake, though?
All cameras.
No, that fuck
got me. There you go. There you go, man.
Was it real?
Anyways, that's real. Like, so Little Kelpy was coming on.
Yeah.
And he was acting like a pimp.
Yeah.
And these motherfuckers he was pimping girls on OnlyFans. And these fools are all like pimps.
Little called him a bitch, though. Like,
yeah, he did.
Like, straight to his face, like, Duffel's all, wait a minute.
And he gave him a second chance.
I called you a bitch.
Who did?
Kelpy.
Kelpy did.
Let's see it. Can you pull it up for me?
Yeah, I'll pull it up. So what happened was he's sitting there and he's talking shit. And he's like, man, no one even knows who the
bombs on him. Like, you could tell us what's up.
Damn.
He goes, no one even knows who the fuck you are. And he goes, I'm Little Kelpy the pimp, bitch. And he goes, wait, what? Who you calling a bitch? He goes, I'm calling you a bitch.
And then that boy just fucking... Kelpy starts bombing on him?
No, Kelpy gets bombed on.
Oh, shit. Let's see this.
That's crazy. I did see just like a snippet of it, you know?
I wasn't sure if it was real.
People were also wondering if it was real.
Yeah, because I saw the snippet on fucking Instagram. I wasn't sure if it was real.
I don't know.
And then he came back on Little Kelpy and talked to fucking... that fool one-on-one.
Yeah, I saw that.
So it really started when he came on with Sharp. You know Sharp?
Sharp always
and
fucking Sharp rubbed me the wrong way.
Annihilated that fool. Made that fool walk off. And he's like, hey, get the fuck out of here. Yeah. Get the fuck off my show. He's like, I don't even want to see you anymore.
Yeah.
And that fool just left. But then he came back acting all fucking, you know,
he was acting all jumpy. Yeah, he was high and mighty after that one.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's see.
At Men's Warehouse this holiday.
We gotta go to Men's Warehouse this holiday.
We're getting there.
That's our sponsorship
about
tonight.
To get myself a
this
suit.
Fucking podcast is brought to you by Men's Warehouse for all your apparel and fucking positive gifts.
I've been there. You've been there.
I went and got a suit from them before.
Cheers, brother.
I've got a suit from them. I would say that I don't expect suits to be expensive as they are sometimes, but they're a little up there. You know,
hey, they got a lot of ads. I'll tell you.
If you got ads, you're doing your thing.
Balling.
Yeah, I mean,
Burger King ad. We're also sponsored by.
When was the last time you wore a suit?
Burger King.
The wedding. Oh, no, it wasn't even.
You weren't wearing a goddamn suit at the wedding.
I wasn't wearing a suit there. I guess the last wedding I was in.
Yeah, that's
the one before that.
Coolest podcast.
All right, we're fast forwarding.
You see that fool? He said he fell on his, in his bathroom. He got up too fast and smashed his head on his bathroom. That's how he got the scar on his head?
No.
Yeah, that's what he was saying.
Jeez.
Yeah. Honestly, I'm going to be real with you. They both look stupid as fuck. Yeah. Like, they're just, it just... I mean, you think
trying to be Michael Jordan at one point, right? And then the next day, boom, you are Michael Jordan.
You gotta crawl before.
He looks normal as fuck. Yeah.
So everybody starts somewhere. I feel like they're hating on that because not even the race thing. Because I feel like we're all the same.
Oh, they blur this shit out.
No way.
They did.
Yeah, because he gets his ass.
Really?
Beat,
why would like, they do that?
He starts leaking.
Fuck out of here.
I ain't never seen no bitches.
Who are you?
He gets him like.
I'm Lil Kelpie. No Kelpie the pimp. Kelpie the motherfucking
Kelpie the clown.
You
fuck
ain't gotta
here.
Know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Fuck out of here.
Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here.
He knows who the fuck I am. I'm
you
getting
said
money
what?
Every day. I said Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a bitch, though?
I'm calling you a bitch.
Ooh. Watch Adam. I'm out of here. Oh, no, I got to break it up. I got to break it up.
Pull it up. You can find it. He sounded like he cracked him fucking good. He sounded like
no,
he cracked
it's not him. That good, bro.
Let's see the real video.
What's wrong with you?
Call me a clown? You call me a bitch? What's wrong with you?
He jumped. They said no jumper. He jumped.
Yeah.
This is the jumper. They won't show his face. It's all blurred out. Does that mean he's bleeding? Damn. Now he just sitting there? Did he get punked or he just doesn't want to fight back?
He got punked.
He starts talking shit again.
Or is he being professional?
He is a bitch.
Oh shit. Watch out for that glass table though.
And that fool's like, this fool's like, what is
can
your
we see
problem?
It? I want to really see it.
Well, is that as good as it gets? Like,
no, you could see
there was another clip.
Yeah,
that's probably from the No Jumper. See, I don't think they actually have the clip on their
page. Jumper. But they'll fucking.
Oh, there it is, right there. Fake pimp gets beat up at Fake No Jumper. Pimp.
Lil Kelpie.
Now, over the last few months, I suppose.
That's when he gets.
That's where he gets punched.
He's been battle tested.
So I guess he been playing.
Started, you know, dipping my foot in the game.
So
Lil Kelpie?
Oh, dude, that fool just looking
Lil Kelpie?
Looking for
no, it doesn't even have that
fool. Okay.
Yeah, it's fake.
Give me that one.
Who are you talking about?
Find out where the arrows on it. See where the arrows is.
Lil Kelpie?
I would get off the internet.
Fuck this fool. I'm done with it. All
right. Well, I wish I could have seen it.
You find out
I mean, it sounds good. I wish I could have seen it.
Does Lil Kelpie have a lot of followers? Or?
So fuck this shit.
I wish I could have
seen it. I just hate giving motherfuckers like that some shine. It's like, fuck this.
You're not giving them shine. You're throwing dark on them.
Nah, fuck that. But yeah, that was a situation that happened. But they got so many views on all that shit and so much publicity off of it. Like, who knows if it was set up?
But
nah, I mean,
nah, that fool got leaked up.
This isn't Jerry Springer.
I think he got beat up for real.
Yeah,
yeah. This ain't no Jerry Springer. This is the No Jumper podcast.
I mean, motherfuckers do some foul ass shit.
He got fake robbed on there.
I don't think they'd blur it out and they'd try to take it off their page though. If it was
no, that's the only thing right there. And that fool was actually leaking.
I'm looking right now. Hopefully, I found it. We'll see.
Yeah.
Jesus
so they took,
Christ.
That's how bad
so
it is.
It's,
you
it's
know it's real.
They,
it off.
They scrubbed the entire internet off that shit.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. You could probably find something.
I don't know, man.
Well, I found it. I already found it. Here it is. Lil Kelpie is a suspect and Lil Kelpie fight, but it scored with SpongeBob music. Here it is.
Put it on the big TV. Just put it on the TV.
Oh, that's kind of weak sauce.
Yeah, it's not even
boom,
that good.
Boom, boom, boom. That's kind of weak sauce.
Oh. What'd you find that on?
YouTube?
Watch. I've seen it.
You seen it?
Yeah.
I thought it was kind
of
weak sauce.
So he's just cracking them a bunch of times, it looks like.
It's not really like
he kind of misses a lot of punches.
He's not fucking.
Not at the end right there.
Yeah, then he gets them. He's getting them. But yeah, I mean, like, fuck, it sounded pretty crucial when they fucking did it up there like that. But yeah, I want to see the bleeding. Let's get to the blood.
The No Jumper. They jumped.
Let's see how he looks right here. So I found it over here. You got, he's pretty lumped up, dude. He looks pretty fucked up at the end.
Split his eyes.
You want to throw it up for us, Sig? Keep the fucking fans looking since he had to cut the room. You could throw it up on the screen, can't you?
Oh, yeah. But what's it? What did you type in for that?
Type in suspect and Lil Kelpie fight, but it's scored with SpongeBob music. I didn't listen to the music, so I don't know what it's really scored with. It's what it says. Yeah, Suspect and Lil Kelpie fight, okay, but it's scored. Okay. It's a minute 20.
Yeah,
is the actual video. So
I could. What the hell?
You didn't find it? You found it?
Well, this is.
I could just send it to you real quick.
Hold on, let me see if I can get on here.
Here you go. I'll send it to you.
I think him.
Here, let me send it to you real quick.
No, I found it. I have it
okay,
on here.
Cool.
I can't get onto the AirPlay right now.
I think he's got it changed. It used to
he
be.
He does.
It was called a back room or whatever. I don't know. It doesn't even come up now.
It says bedroom something.
It's the kids in the house watching TV.
And I don't want to go to that one.
Yeah, you don't want to put that one on.
What do you think about San Francisco has employed robots to kill people?
Is that true? I heard. Yes, I've seen that too.
It's true.
Rogan posted that.
They voted to allow police to use deadly robots for like.
I feel like
it's situations
so turning like, into iRobot.
This is NBC
crazy
News.
Crazy hostage situations.
Yeah. Yeah. This is on TMZ, but also NBC, all the major news sites. RoboCop essentially will be out there, possibly killing people if he sees some shit going down. Do you think that's good for San Francisco? Is it going to clean up the streets?
I mean, yeah, they're probably going to shoot a bunch of homeless people.
That? I mean, like, what?
I think it's to kill the homeless.
A lot of different situations that can play to something that a robot might not understand.
Mm.
I mean, what are they? What's their capabilities? You know, like.
Yeah. Well, this man right here, there's some man that's a San Francisco resident. He's pretty fearful of people hacking into these fucking robots and using it for their advantage. What do you think of these robots being now allowed in San Francisco to kill people, use deadly force to...
I think we should take all the robots, line them all up, and take their heads off and cut them off and light them up and kill them all.
Yeah, kill the robots?
Kill the robots.
How are we going
to
do that?
We need to kill all robots.
Kill how? Robots? How? Remember, this is like iRobot.
Yeah, remember iRobot?
You can't kill them.
You need to kill the chip.
Armies, the guy has one arm and he's still fucking shit up the whole movie. Kill the chip. The whole movie. He's fucking shit up with one arm.
Shit's getting weird, dude.
I believe it.
What about
shit's getting weird.
The video of the one robot that was shooting the guns and they were turning that fool around.
That was fake. They said that was fake.
That was
where he kicks him, where he's kicking him over and everything.
Damn it,
yeah, they said it was fake. But
it
was.
Why do you let a fucking truth get in the way of a good story?
I mean,
dude?
It's a good story.
You're going to go on a good run right there.
Hey, okay, how about this? How do you feel about robots in general? Just in general.
I hate
helping
them.
You out.
No.
You wouldn't want a robot. Say at work, your buddy's a robot now. And he stands the floors while you're doing other things. You
Matthew,
don't want that?
Have you not seen Terminator?
Yeah.
Then what are we doing?
Hasta la vista, baby.
This ain't a naked robot. This is a normal robot.
I'll be back.
Matt, these robots are all going to develop. They're all AI robots.
Yeah.
They have to be AI at some point.
Yeah, they're going
to
get smarter.
Your phone learns you and learns all this good stuff about you and how to fucking treat you. Robots are going to do that too, but they're also going to learn all the bad things about you.
Yeah,
and
they're
going to
get
you.
And they're going to get you. Yeah, I believe it.
So why do you want a robot to come fold your clothes when you just fold them yourself?
I don't
need
some guy folding my
clothes.
Wrong
with that. I mean, I wouldn't mind a robot helping me at work though every day. Like say you got a heavy lifting
until
job.
Until the day
the
that
robot
you're
lift shit every day.
Until the
you.
Day you're sitting there like, hey robot, go get me a fucking wrench. And he's like, all right.
Go get me a beer.
Matthew,
and then he hits you with the wrench in the head.
I have come and give you the wrench for the very last time.
Oh,
I want
shit.
Your soul.
That's true. That could happen. That could happen at some point.
I'm just saying, man.
Yeah. AI is tricky. AI's
thing.
That kid got his finger broken or finger ripped off or whatever.
Yeah, for playing chess with the robot.
The robot got pissed off during the chess game.
A little kid was playing chess with it.
I don't trust the robot thing either.
He thought the kid was going to cheat or something like that. So it broke the kid's finger.
You?
No, I haven't heard about
it's like a 12-year-old.
You ain't heard about that?
I didn't hear about that.
Yeah, so this little kid, this 12-year-old chess champion was playing an AI robot. One of the
that could stand and walk a robot?
No, it was a robot that had hands that just moved. It was just a head and hands.
He was 7 years old. Sorry, seven, the kid.
And he fucking ripped this kid's finger off, reached over and said, checkmate, fuck you.
You're lying.
Yeah, basically.
Can you show me the video?
I don't think.
He didn't say the checkmate, fuck you, but he just reached over and ripped this fool's
give
finger
me
off.
Your finger.
Why?
Your finger is mine now. Yeah. I will be taking that.
That's pretty wicked, dude.
Please sit on my face.
Yeah, there's
what'd you say?
Sit on my face.
How did they hear me?
There's a video, but it's just like
how did he see me?
You know.
How did he see me?
Yep. Yeah, there's a video, but it's kind of weird. Oh shit!
Can we see it?
Oh,
can we see this?
Well, you gotta put it up.
Up.
I don't have access
it
for some reason
screen,
anymore.
Yeah. Why are you fucking us? Man?
I've been
put
denied.
The
oh no, I got it. Hold on, I got it. I got it.
I know you act like you can't do it yourself.
No, I for a while I couldn't.
He was. We were all.
I was
nervous.
Trying. I was trying.
It only said back bedroom is what it said.
Yes, yes.
It didn't
yes.
say secret fucking studio. Podcast studio.
Oh, it says studio.
See? Things are just going a little.
Huh. I got a sign that we should get for the studio, too. I seen one. What the fuck?
Ripped that fool's finger off of it.
He's okay, it's a 70-year-old's
turn. So did it just stall out on his finger, or it just said, fuck you, I'm grabbing your finger?
It's an AI robot.
I get it. It didn't just like stall out and grab him.
You know what AI is, right?
Yeah, artificial what is robot just fucking this kid
learns.
Up.
It just constantly is learning.
So he was beating the robot?
The robot thought he was going to cheat because
the robot was rented by the U.S. It has been exhibited in many places by specialists for a long time. Apparently, the operators overlooked some flaws. As it ripping fingers off was what they overlooked. I'm sure
it could rip your dick off. Essentially, imagine if it grabbed onto his.
What if the kid? What if the thing was meant or to anyone's. Be like? If it makes this move ever, this move never gets made. But if homie makes this move, you rip his fucking finger off. Ugh. And the hundreds of thousands of people that play on it every day never make the move. And this kid went up and
see.
Made
I'm
the
all
secret
for
move
AI. I'm all for AI in the sense of like how our phones help us and how music is cool, like the algorithm and finding new music and giving me the music that I like instead of having to hear bullshit. It gives me all the shit that I like.
Yeah.
I enjoy that. But AI going to like. The point where you have robots that are actually able to capitalize and have capabilities of moving and using their brain to actually gain strategic advantages over humans, this is not a good thing.
If a robot saved your life, would you be okay with it?
Yes, but if he can save your life, he can also injure
you. I know, but would it make you change your mind? Like, say you got a crazy-ass car crash and it was burning, you were about to burn up, and no humans can get in there, and they sent the robot in, and he pulled the cars off of you, and he pulled you out of the fucking car.
Wouldn't feel differently? Take him home?
No, you wouldn't.
And then one day he goes, you are a piece of shit, and I will want to kill you.
No, but you wouldn't feel differently a little bit if they saved your life?
What if he goes, I will wear your skin now?
Oh, shit. Damn. They find him walking around the yard with all your patchy skin all over him. Like, he's in the backyard acting like it's you, picking up dog shit and stuff.
This is what I'm
crazy.
Saying.
That'd be crazy.
Dude, and it could happen.
One thing that AI could do, though, here's something for us, is what if there was a program or an app, an AI app, that could tell you data on, like, everything throughout your life, like give you straight data of like the movie, what movie you've watched the most time, what songs you've heard the most time.
Called Spotify.
How many
Spotify
times? How many times have
you
come?
To?
Oh. No, throughout your whole life. I'm talking
that'd
about.
That'd be pretty crazy. How would the robot know how many times you?
Yeah,
came
for him, he'd have to be there the whole time.
Dummy, I'm talking about an AI computer that has an app that fucking had all these fucking things like that knew everything throughout your whole life.
So would you have to hook it up while you were born
born? Yes. It would start as you were born.
Yeah.
What would be one of the things that you would want it to know the most, the one thing that you did the most throughout your life?
Masturbated.
You think it's in
the
thousands?
I'm curious, how
many
times?
How many times you masturbated? Shoot, we're in the tens of thousands probably, easily. I mean, you figure if you got 365 in a year, sometimes you hit it twice a day on a normal day, on a weekend or whatever, you know. You're just a lonely guy one day, you know, before you had a lady, you're at a home, you know, you live at your home still, your house with your parents, and you're like 15, 16, you might hit it twice a day, you know. You know, you never know.
Shit, come home all coked out.
You never know. Hey, am I wrong? You tell me you never yanked the chain twice in one day. I'm sure we all have here. So, I mean, think about
in
it.
High school?
Now, if you're hitting twice a day at a 365, maybe, at that whole year you're 15, you might have yanked it twice in the morning when you get home.
Over 700.
In the morning when you wake up, when you got home from school. You're over 700 already right there in one year.
You're doing mornings and nights?
If you're in high school, I got a little, something in me, a little morning motivation.
What time are you waking up? What time are you waking up for this morning masturbation session?
Even Slug says it. Or you know, something in me got a little, you know the song.
I know, but is he in high school at that point? I think he's
he's a grown man. Yeah, I mean, you don't yank the chain in the morning still?
I would like to know how many.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Let's back it up. As a grown man now, you don't yank the chain in the morning still?
In
every
the morning?
Once in a while, you never hit
every
the quick.
Once in
I
a
do
while.
Once in a while.
Once in a while, you got time, you hit the
but
chain.
But it's
game.
Not like you're saying every morning and every night.
No,
for 365 days.
When you're 15.
Maybe when I was like 15.
When you're 15, yeah. That's what I'm talking. Those numbers. Then.
Not even then.
Come on. Who are you, Jesus?
Not twice. No, I'm not Jesus. But I was only masturbating probably at night.
Never, come on. Never twice in one day?
No, not never. I'm not saying. I'm saying every day.
Not every single day.
Not every single day, but if you're 15.
Five times a week.
Yeah, if you're 15, you at least get some good numbers in. More numbers than I've ever hit, you know, lately. Any
number. For
but
sure.
Yeah. So,
you're hitting like 10 a week.
Yeah, for sure. So if you look at it like that, your numbers are probably super high. You got to at least got to be in the nines to 10,000. You don't think?
Probably
and you're 20s. 30 fucking 6 years old. Come
20,000s.
Yeah.
You're hitting 40 a month.
Yeah, for sure. Those are good numbers. And if you're not, you need to get your numbers up. You need to get your numbers up. It's healthy.
My guy's a professional.
Get your numbers
up. Keep those numbers up a little
40 yeah. a month.
You know it. Get the fucking numbers up.
40 times 12.
What's that? That's 4 times 12. We don't, 4, even, 000, we don't do math.
48. 48.
4,800.
Okay.
4,800 times a year times 36 times 36
times 36 4,800 times 36
yeah well, 36 okay no say you probably started masturbating years. Like 14 oh, right okay. So 13 14 20, so
22 years yeah,
22 years time, times 4,800
yeah yeah I mean, 22 I'm sure times 4,800 chain before I was 14
4,800
There yeah, there's the number.
What's the number?
105,600.
You didn't jerk off over 105,000.
Jesus Christ. You dick tired. That dick tired.
My guy's a professional.
Yeah.
No wonder why you had trouble having kids.
For real. Hey, you know what they say, though, is if you do something over 10,000 hours, you're a professional.
Yeah. Dude, you're
a fucking professional.
You are a fucking.
You're a pro, bro.
You can land that plane upside down.
Yes.
My you guy. Can do heart surgery blindfolded. You know what I mean?
Dick surgery.
My guy earned his wings.
I would want to know, like, how many miles I've traveled
on the
throughout
dick?
My whole life.
For, like, oh, like,
no, no, no. Like, but if we could do, like, a stat throughout your whole life, how many miles you've traveled.
That'd be probably cool.
Traveled a lot. Or how many states you've hit, or I guess you could do that.
You could do that yourself.
Yeah.
Mm. How many hours you've spent
I haven't even gone
playing video games.
I've been fucking places. Shit. I've got some hours.
What movie do you think you've watched the most out your whole life? Mm.
Good question. Good question.
Just in general, I think about
it's Back just to the that
future.
One.
I'm gonna
it's
say
that one.
Ace Ventura: Pet Detective. Ace Ventura for me, maybe because I've seen it a lot.
Mine has to be a movie that I watched when I was a kid and when I was older, so it's probably Goonies.
Oh, Goonies is good, dude.
Because I've watched it. Or Home Alone. Actually, you know what? Time
Home Alone
out.
2. Home Alone 1 is really okay. good.
Home Alone 2. It's probably Home Alone 2.
Home Alone 2 is my favorite.
I watched it so much when I was a kid, and I've watched it a lot as an adult.
Well, I haven't watched the first one, too.
Home Alone 2. Home Alone 2
is very good.
Home Alone 2.
Home Alone 2.
I didn't watch Back to the Future until...
I started
actually
watching
when
that
I was a kid.
Was
yeah, when I was yeah, young. I was yeah. Like, TBS.
Seven. You're telling me that you can word out Home Alone 1. I could word it out.
Home Alone 1 and 2.
Home Alone
2.
One,
yeah.
Fucking,
I like when he, I like when his sister tells him, you're what the French call
les compétents.
Les
I was young. That was my favorite part.
My favorite part is when his brother fucking throws the bag down the thing. Bombs away.
Yeah.
Every
land
time,
right at homie's feet.
So every time we would go, we'd grow up in a house with like stairs. So anytime I went to a place that had stairs, I would always go to the top and throw like a pillar or something and go, bombs away.
Yeah.
That's a great part.
I just like when he says, Buzz, your girlfriend. Woof.
My daughter.
Oh,
so
yeah.
She's 3 now, but when she was 2 last year, that was, so we were watching Home Alone all the time, and that was her favorite part. And so she was just going around everywhere. Everywhere she'd go, just out of nowhere, Buzz, your girlfriend. Woof.
That's a kill line.
And she was just killing him with that.
The secret, though, is, you know about the secret, who that guy is, though, right?
Who?
That's actually a dude
who
plays his Buzz's girlfriend, the pitcher, and he's the director's
really?
One of the director's sons.
Really?
Yeah, one of the people that helped make the movie. It's his son.
In a wig or something.
Yes, look it up. It's true facts. The guy that's in the actual fucking that pitcher of Buzz's girlfriend
is
one
a
of the
guy.
One of the producers.
Oh, did she find that
yeah,
out?
It's a boy, and he's one of the producer's that's sons. That is in the actual movie. That's the, oh, that man. Made the pick. He made the pick, and that was what the funny thing is.
Hey, can you turn my mic down a hair? Or the headphones down a hair?
Yeah, that's what always made me laugh. When I found that out, it always made me always like,
it could be it could definitely be a...
Look it up. Who is this? from Buzz's girlfriend is actually a guy from the pic. I'll type that in for you. I got
yeah,
you.
Give it a type.
That is the most random shit right there.
Give it a
How
type.
Do you know that?
Yeah, it's legit.
And I'll pull it up on here. There's a Buzz's old girl.
Oh!
Buzz's old girl.
Girlfriend.
Woof! Oh,
that's a dude?
Yeah, that's actually a dude.
There's Buzz himself.
The secret behind Buzz's girlfriend in Home Alone. Here it is right here. Okay. The actor who played Buzz in the comedy classic Home Alone confesses about his character's real girlfriend in Home Alone. Everyone in the So Sensitive in Home Alone remaking Buzz's girlfriend. Oh, okay. But eventually the director Chris Columbus knew he couldn't have a girl that age come in and make fun of her.
Okay.
So
okay.
Instead, he put a very...
Just make fun of the little boy dressed as a woman.
Very beautiful girl.
A little girl.
Obnoxious bully brother. Da, a little da, girl. Da, 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 da. He's going through his brother's trunk. He pulls out Buzz's girlfriend. Frame lovely. Images of a flick. Back in the day, he said the homie... Da, 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 just fly. Current social... Kevin probably sums up as wolf. Intro TBS. Cringe because seriously. I'll find it.
Well, man, that is some amazing information.
Thanks, man. I'm going to find it for you. Turns out that neither is true. Buzz's girlfriend. Okay, here it is. Here it is. Turns out neither is true. Buzz's girlfriend isn't actually a girl at all.
It's not.
Actor Devin Rattray is finally revealed and is a big secret behind Buzz's girlfriend. Look up Devin Rattray.
Who's that?
That's the guy who played Buzz's girlfriend. That's the pitcher.
Devin Rattray?
Devin Rattray. R-A-T-R-A-Y.
Oh, my God.
Buzz's girlfriend. Type that in and see what you get.
Oh, wait, no. The guy's on Cobra Kai.
That's the guy. That's the guy.
This is amazing.
That's Buzz.
That's Buzz. That's Buzz.
That's Buzz.
Yeah, you're tripping.
Come on. Buzz's girlfriend actor Devin Rattray.
Time out. Is what you're saying is Buzz played Buzz's girlfriend.
Okay. It turns out the producer of the movie knew that.
It was Buzz's girlfriend.
Okay. Wow, really?
Go back to the picture.
No. It says right here. Sorry. The role was actually given to a very eager and willing boy to play the girlfriend, says Devin. Okay, so who it is? It doesn't say. It says here.
An eager young boy that wants to play this girl. He's so eager to play this.
I don't know.
Who is this little boy?
I don't know.
Sounds like this is fake news to me.
No, it's real. It's real. It's there. Fake it's news. It's still here. They can't make fun of it. I didn't really know
that Devin Rattray, Buzz, is in Cobra Kai, though. I didn't make that connection until now. So fucking weird. Fucking weird. Name three movies Macaulay Culkin's in besides Home Alone right now.
Oh, I got you.
Children of the Corn.
Party Monster.
Children of the Corn.
Page Master. No, sorry. Step Brothers.
The Good Brother.
The Good Son.
Yes.
good job naming one finally.
The Good Son. Party Monster.
Page Master.
And Page Master. That was three, yeah.
Page Master's a classic.
Page Master's classic.
Hold on, time out. I got one. Uncle Buck.
Ooh,
classic. I got something else.
Getting Even with Dad.
That Michael Jackson movie he's in.
Richie Rich.
Yes.
Damn, how did we miss that one?
Come on, man. Classic. I love Richie Rich. Don't you?
Dude, I still watch that shit.
My girl.
Hey, you got McDonald's at your house?
Damn.
My girl, too.
Richie Rich had McDonald's at the house.
Richie Rich did.
At his house, yeah.
Yes, at the house.
The roller coaster in the backyard. McDonald's in the house. That shit was pretty fucking hard.
My girl, good one.
He did play himself. Look it.
Okay.
Let me see.
So it's been confirmed Buzz.
Played Buzz's girlfriend.
Devin Rattray played fucking himself with the wig.
So something I learned about Home Alone 3 is it was in production for Macaulay Culkin to come back.
What?
And they were going to film it right after number 2.
They have Home Alone 3, though.
Listen,
they?
Yeah. But that same film. But that same film was ready for Macaulay Culkin to film. And it got pushed off, and then they were going to have him come back as a teenager and do, like, he's ditching school and staying home, which was basically the same thing
that kid...
No, it's what number three is. Number three, the kid gets sick and stays home.
Yeah, he stays home, yeah.
But they were going to do, like, he, like, fakes sick and stays home and then has to fight off the same people. Harry and Marv were supposed to come back. And they couldn't Macaulay Culkin said that he wasn't coming back because he was, like, retiring.
Harry said, fuck no. And then Marv said, fuck no.
Yeah, they were saying he was going to retire.
Joe Pesci was in, but Homie was not.
No, they said.
Sticky Bandits.
Yeah, for real. Yeah.
The Wet Bandits.
The Wet Bandits.
Yeah. But he wants to be the Sticky Bandits. He wants to be the Stickies.
So Macaulay Culkin was going to retire from acting, and he wasn't going to come back. And so Harry and Marv backed out. But then they wanted to bring in Floyd, which is his cousin, which is also his real little brother in real life. Kieran Culkin.
Yeah, I know.
You know what I'm talking about.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. He's Floyd. He's the one that wets his
Culkin.
Sheets.
It's just Culkin.
McCulkin.
And
it's no McCulkin. It's just Culkin.
Anyways,
no, it's McCulkin.
They were going to bring that kid back.
Macaulay Culkin. I guess it is Culkin.
Not Macaulay McCulkin.
Macaulay Culkin some breakfast.
Matt's with me.
I got you. I know you're talking about.
They were bringing that kid back, and they were going to do a story with him where they went to Harry and Marv want to fucking take over the cousin. And so
Frank
was going to be a main part of the movie. The dickhead Uncle Frank. Can't get out of here, little pervert. Yes. He was going to be a main part of the movie. And, but the little brother was like, I don't want to do it. I can't do that to my brother.
Let me ask you this.
So then they went a whole new route, got a new director because the other fool wasn't coming back. And then they got a whole new actor.
Do you like the third one?
Did Home Alone 3. I watched it.
I don't mind it.
It was pretty good. And guess what?
I don't mind it.
Cisco and Ebert.
The dragon?
Said it was the best one of all
time. Get the fuck out of here. It has horrible reviews. There's no way Cisco or Ebert.
The third one is good, but it's not the best one. It's not the best one.
On the cover of the fucking VHS, it says Ebert. This is the best Home Alone of the series.
Oh, so they pay him to say that?
No, Cisco. We're Cisco.
And Cisco. They both. No, well, Cisco says it.
Cisco died.
If Ebert said it, Cisco said it.
See, it was Cisco
the dragon.
And Ebert.
Yeah, it was Cisco the dragon and Ebert said it.
Cisco said it was the best.
I always wanted to know. How about this?
Cisco.
It was Cisco and fucking E-Jerk. This was the question.
But
all night long.
So when Macaulay Culkin pinches the hot blonde's ass in the middle of the road, do you think he really pinched her ass in the movie, or how do you think they really went on with that?
He pinched her ass. It's the 90s.
No, you know, you give her a little squeaky squeak.
Like, go ahead, pinch her ass.
How many times do you think they had to run that clip?
Remember when we were school, we used to just run around.
Like, oh, I don't think you got it. Pinch her ass again.
All right.
It was a different time.
He gave her like the two finger pinch.
He gave her a little graspy on her.
And then Harry or Marv's like, oh, she was hot.
He gave her that fucking eye.
She was hot.
Mon chéri.
He's
an old perv. He gave her the old perv.
What a good movie, dude. That's probably the movie I've watched the most in my whole life.
Very good, very good.
How about you? Once again, Ace Ventura, Pet Detective, I'm
going
to say.
Where are you going with?
I don't know. I mean, both those movies, honestly, could be either one for me as well.
I mean, Adam Sandler, probably one of his, too. Maybe Happy Gilmore.
One of them for me.
I don't remember Adam Sandler when I was that young. Well, no, Happy Gilmore, you're right. Fuck.
Happy Gilmore, Billy Madison, all that shit.
One for me, though.
Fast Times.
I used to watch Fast Times a lot when I was a kid.
Yeah, Fast Times. Original.
Yeah, but not the most.
We would always rewind it when you come over. We always rewind it when the black kid had the cig falling out of his mouth over and over.
Yeah, but that's not the movie you've watched the most in your whole life.
Yeah, because I mean, think about it, though, because Home Alone comes around Christmas here. Watch that motherfucker every year.
Yeah.
And I watch that thing not even on Christmas. So I watch it half Christmas, too.
Yeah, I watch it. I watch it in July.
It's hard to compete with that. I would honestly probably have to say
That's a good one, dude. And I mean, there's a lot of good Christmas movies, but that one always takes the cake for me for Christmas movies.
And you watch it.
Is your number one Christmas movie?
I would say that, or Chevy Chase's Christmas is really good, too. Yeah, that's really good, too.
Two classics, for sure.
You liked European Vacation? Did you watch the new Vacation?
No, I didn't watch the new one.
I watched it.
It's good, huh?
It was
what
good.
Did I tell you?
It was good.
Do you know what I watched?
It was good. Actually,
tell me he doesn't act like Chevy Chase.
Forrest Gump is really good.
I've watched Forrest Gump hella times.
You ever seen This Is the End?
Yeah,
I've seen when he's outside, he's like, I just hate parties. He's like, you probably hate American cult classic movies too. He's like, what do you think of Forrest Gump? It's trash. He's like, what? You don't like Forrest Gump?
Jesus.
He goes, life is like a box of chocolates. Come on, man.
Forrest Gump's amazing.
You know what I'm talking about? Do you know what I'm talking about or not?
Juan, isn't that a...
I don't remember, but I remember it's this sippy, is the end
when
time.
He, when he steps out back during the party and he's having a cigarette with the girl from Harry Potter and Craig Robinson. And Craig Robinson goes...
Play the clip.
Ah, we don't need to play it, but it's a good movie. Anyways, Christmas Vacation is my favorite.
I like that one.
What's yours?
Out of Christmas movies, I'm going to go... To be honest, though, I watch it a lot, actually. I totally forgot about this one. What's it called? Turbo Time. Arnold Schwarzenegger,
Jingle All the Way.
That one's totally good too.
Your wife's in the shower right now. You want me to go get her? No, stay out of there.
Yes. I forgot about that one this year.
Howard, your wife just baked some cookies.
Yes. I'm not the pervert. When they're all hitting him with the purses inside the mall, he's trying to get the ball from the little kid. I'm not the pervert. That's one of my favorite parts ever, dude.
Yeah, I've been thinking about
Sinbad's in there.
Sinbad's down bad right now.
Yeah, T's and P's.
T's and P's of Sinbad, dude.
T's and P's.
He's got cancer and he's going through a lot of shit.
He's got stroke.
Yeah, but he's going through a lot of stuff right now.
He's got through health issues.
He's got some health issues. So. But yeah, I do love that movie a lot.
Vern Troyer, fucking Mini-Me's in it.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
They got
Big Show's in it.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's fucking A. Movie.
Yeah, that movie's good, dude. Oh, you're going to town, huh? I like your style.
They got a cast.
How much eating?
They got a cast. I didn't know.
Oh, good luck, my friend.
Yeah, yeah, man. I gotta
watch
that.
You're going. You're going. I'm going to go, too.
This one's going.
I got to watch that.
You want to go?
You've been watching Christmas movies already?
Commitments.
Yeah.
Are you fully in already?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Every day you're watching a Christmas movie?
I already watched Friday After Next. Are you watched Harold and Kumar?
I forgot Friday. Bro.
Damn, Harold and Kumar. I forgot that one.
You know what I watched? I watched Batman the other day. Batman and Robin. That's a Christmas movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh yeah, yeah.
About to dig into Die Hard 1.
Die Hard is on my list as
Jesus, these look dangerous.
Definitely classics, bro.
Yeah, I'm already fully in. We're watching all the Christmas movies. I think the first go-tos are always Home Alones.
And yeah, I started with two this time.
The Grinch with Jim Carrey is a classic. Mm-hmm. Got to go to.
Did not watch it yet, but I will. Oh, what do you think of The Christmas Carol with Jim Carrey? Have you seen it?
Yeah, not my favorite.
You don't like it, huh?
You want to know a sneaky good movie that you guys should all watch?
A sneaky sneak.
A good Christmas movie? Scrooged with Bill Murray.
I've seen it, and it's pretty good. It's pretty good.
So good.
I've never actually watched the whole thing.
Class.
It's about the ghost that visit him. They show his life, what it could be.
Yeah, it's a classic Scrooge story, but it's with Bill fucking Murray.
Classic. What I just watched. Groundhog's Day. Oh, that's a fucking classic, too.
What you got?
That's not a Christmas movie, though. That's a February movie. That's our birthday movie.
I know.
The Christmas movie that I just watched today, one of my favorites, Bad Santa. You guys like Bad Santa?
No,
you guys
not
like
a fan. Not a fan.
Why
not
don't
a
you
fan.
Like Bad like Santa?
I'm not a Billy Bob Thornton fan.
Really?
He rubbed me the wrong way. Why? Tickles my jingle.
Since Blood In, Blood Out, he rubbed me the wrong way.
He's a prick.
Damn, huh?
He's a piece of shit.
I ain't a Billy Bob type
blood
guy.
Blood In, Blood Out.
I like remember? That's motherfucking.
You tell him, Ryder.
Yep, fucking Ryder. I'm going to make you kiss your own boot. You got to shine it, brother. Make it with his boot and his mate. You're going to pay for this. You ain't beers are going to fucking pay for this.
Bro,
now go ahead and crawl to me. Now go ahead and crawl to me now.
They fucking did
they
that so dirty
they
on the
get yard. You now go ahead and crawl to me now.
Slap that mic. I hear a static. A statty stack.
I got
there
you.
There you go. Perfect.
Yeah, that's a mean fucking movie, dude. One of my favorite movies ever, though, dude.
All right, so we're talking Christmas movies. Here's something that I brought up for Halloween.
What you got?
I said TV shows, Christmas episodes. What's your favorite Christmas episode?
Because
once again, Fresh Prince has some good ones. Full House, I went to Full House, had some great fucking Christmas episodes where they get stuck in the airport. Step by Step had a good fucking one. Family Matters has a Christmas one.
I don't remember any good Christmas episodes. As like a show.
You want the best Besides one that I've watched so far?
That 70 Show is a pretty good one.
The best one I've watched so far is Home Improvement.
Christmas?
Forgot about
That's the one with Pamela Anderson in it still, right?
Yes, it's season one, and it's he's having a light off with his neighbor, and he's trying to light up his house hella bright. Yes. And she's like, don't do it, don't do
it. That's when he falls off the roof, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and he's upside down hanging. Yeah. Classic, dude. Classic. Isn't it crazy to think that the whole time him and JTT, John Taylor Thomas, they had a beef the whole time after the first season. Like, they didn't like each other.
Really?
Yeah.
Couldn't see it on camera.
Yeah, you couldn't tell on camera.
Their chemistry was like this.
Right?
Wow. Chemistry was like
they
that.
They were beefing?
Like it was really his son.
Could you tell?
Tim and JTT?
Look it up. They had a real beef.
Did you know this, though? They killed JTT off? He dies.
How does he die?
He dies. In the last season, he like gets cancer or something and dies.
You're a liar.
No.
I'm not believing
look
this.
Look into
hype.
It.
Yeah, I got to see this.
They kill him off because he didn't want to come back, and they thought they were going to keep going. And then once they said JTT was not coming back, the studio was like, oh, we're shutting this thing down because he was hot at the time. He was the one.
And he doesn't die after all.
What happens?
So he does get something. But then
that's the very end, right?
He finds out he has a cancer scare. It's just a scare.
That's it.
Yeah.
He was beefing with Tim so hard. Tim's like, we need to.
Anyway, that was the end of this.
My favorite Christmas episode, Seinfeld, bro, which you don't even know anything about, probably.
Seinfeld sucks. He doesn't seem like a Seinfeld guy.
I mean, it's a fucking.
I love Seinfeld.
It's a great one.
Seinfeld.
Is that Christmas really or no? What is it? What is he called? It. Don't tell me. Fuck, don't say it. Don't even say it.
The silver pole?
No, I know. Don't even say it. His dad is super big on it.
Yes, he loves it.
What is it?
George's dad makes up his own holiday because he hates Christmas. He hates all the fucking commercial shit involved with it.
I know. What is it called?
He happens to be a Jewish man, too.
What is it fucking called? It's don't tell me. Don't tell me.
And he make George is passing out fake Christmas gifts.
What is it?
It's Festivus.
Festivus.
For the rest of us.
That's the best.
And they get a big giant fucking metal pole instead.
What's your favorite Seinfeld episode?
Favorite Seinfeld episode of all time?
You watch Seinfeld?
I do not.
Did you used to?
Nah.
What you got?
I mean, that's a really good one, personally. You know, like there's so many. It's hard to pick just one. I love many episodes.
You know? I love a mini episode.
Give me a one. I love give a mini one episode. That one that stands out to you. Give me a good standout.
One that stands out. Workaholics. Half Christmas.
Half Christmas?
Good ones. That's a good one.
July?
I used to love Workaholics. I should have
loved it. Yeah, they celebrate half Christmas, and it's like they're going around doing caroling, and they go to a door that starts off their caroling, and you think, oh, shit, it must be Christmas. Like, okay, it's a Christmas episode.
Oh,
and the I've dude opens it. The door and goes, it's fucking July. And then like, it cuts to the fucking intro.
Is that the first
intro.
Season still or no?
No, it's like season they four fell off or
after the first season.
No, they feel like. Workaholics?
First and second season were the best.
You're out of your mind, bro. The very last season's the best season there is.
You think so? The first season was the best.
No, you're true. You first didn't watch it, best. Obviously.
Come I thought they were all good. What did you guys think of that movie they made?
Awesome. Game Over Man was sick.
I don't know if I've seen it.
With Daniel Stern's in it. Harry's.
Oh, yeah.
Marv is in it.
Yes, he is.
Marv gets his dick cut off in it.
No.
Yeah. Marv looks different.
Let me see him.
He's very bearded. A bearded man now.
Marv gets big his dick beard. Cut off in it. That's a great fucking movie when that fool's all, you can't fucking eat his ass. He's like, you think I'm scared of eating booty?
What do you think the best
or when the two killers, they're like, they're all hiding in the room because there's like two dudes that are fucking the bad guys that are chasing them, right? And they turned out to be gay, and they're like, all this shit is just really turning me on. And they start fucking on the bed, and the fools are underneath the bed where they're fucking. Right, yeah. Oh, man.
Jesus.
That's actually a pretty good movie, yeah.
That's him now. He just.
That's Marv?
He looks the same. He just looks old
as
fuck.
Maybe just an older guy.
How about this, though?
Put him in Game Over, Man.
If you were to tell somebody to watch a movie, best movie ever, you could just say, this is ever? The all-time my favorite. If you don't like it, you're crazy. Best ever.
Oh.
What are you going for? Like just someone who's like a weird movie too. It's got to be weird. It's got to like shoot you. It's got to like shoot you like a just kind of a weird way.
Oh yeah, Goodfellas are Training Day.
Those are great. If I was to tell you one, I think everyone would love it if they seen it. Talented Mr. Ripley.
Yeah.
What's his name? That's in it.
It's got to be easy to follow though.
No.
It's like too much. It's got to be like easy to follow, good story.
How is it easy to follow? The guy pretends to be somebody else, and he goes and visits the guy that killed him and takes over his life.
You guys could kill me for this, but I got one. This is for this person never seen a movie before.
All right,
he's about to sit down and watch a movie.
First movie ever. This is what you're going to show the AI. First movie you're going
to
show your robot. Let's see.
Give it to him. All
right, what are you going
to
give him?
Phenomenon with John Travolta.
Oh my god. This man loves horrible movies. The man gets a tumor. He doesn't have really superpowers the whole time. He's kind of
easy to follow.
I'll show him The Matrix.
Easy to follow.
Yeah, you're going to confuse the man to death.
Too much.
Phenomenon's too much. The man doesn't have powers.
Didn't he just have a brain tumor. Didn't he just allegedly have a tumor?
No, he has a brain tumor.
Are you sure it's Michelle better?
Are you sure it's Michelle? At the end of the movie, they talk about how he has a brain tumor and everything he was doing wasn't real. Like when he's in the bar and he breaks the mirror.
I remember
that
gets brought up. Okay. Confirmed,
Pulp Fiction. Something with Travolta. It's got to be something with Travolta.
Pulp Fiction's kill.
Or something with Cruise.
Fear and Loathing Las Vegas.
Or do we do
classic. Vanilla Sky?
No, not too deep.
That's a good one.
Something easy for them.
007. No. Mission Impossible.
Yeah. Too much
for a kiddo.
Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless.
Oh, Jerry Maguire.
Risky Business.
Jerry Maguire.
Jerry fucking Maguire. Or Risky Business.
Jerry Maguire's good.
Jerry Maguire or Risky Business.
Yeah.
Show me the money.
Boogie Nights.
My Jerry Maguire for sure.
Oh, man.
Boogie Nights? Jesus Christ. For a child?
50 Cent had Ken Shamrock, the world's most dangerous man, as his personal bodyguard.
When?
From Lockwood?
You didn't know this?
When?
He hired that man for a while, yeah. If you could have any guy as your own personal bodyguard,
you know who I'm going to pick?
Who?
Teddy Hart.
Teddy Hart?
Teddy Hart, man.
And we'll get into that doc a little bit, too.
I haven't watched it, so you can't fucking spoil
for me,
it.
Bro.
You
actually,
I've seen
to
it all.
Watch it.
Actually, I've seen
you're
him.
Lying.
I've seen him on so many shoot interviews.
It's not
I've
about
seen
that.
Shoot interviews and podcasts
it's
where he talks about all those
that.
Stories. Yes, he
about
talks
about the chick that's missing.
Yes, he's talked about all those stories.
It's about a chick that's missing.
How many times
much.
Has he been on Keeping It 100?
At times, because like he's homies with Conan.
Times. I heard all this shit years ago.
They're saying straight up, he's saying that because he was in jail at the time she went missing.
Yeah,
but it couldn't be that she went missing before he went to jail. They're not for sure the timeline.
This
but,
documentary is called Dangerous Breed. It just came out on Peacock. It's a
three-part
little thing. Three-part documentary. I thought it was really good. I also have always known about Teddy Hart. He's the nephew of Bret Hart and
Owen Hart. All I gotta say is that house probably smelled like shit.
The mansion,
what do
you call it?
The mansion? The fool has over 50 cats.
He had hundreds.
Yeah, hundreds cats piss, bro. And they Persian stinks. Cats. Could you imagine?
And like, and then he has his young, really his young boys, boys. Right. The you young ever boys.
Been to someone's house who had cats and they piss.
Yeah, it's fucking. He has a, then he has young boys come in. These little young wrestlers that want to be wrestlers are like, you want to get to be a wrestler? This is what we got.
2,000 a month.
You got to learn how to take care of my cats.
Yep. 2,000 a month.
And they, like, all these guys have all this food and they're like bringing it and scooping this cat shit.
Wasn't it crazy to think that it all turned? You thought he was really having a luxurious life with these two chicks, having like threesomes with them, and then it all turns out that he's just like kind of.
He hired the girl like to keeping pose. Them.
You know who the real scumbag is in the whole thing?
The director?
Yeah,
the filmmaker. He filmed the whole thing.
Well, no, this is the whole thing. Then he comes back and says, "This is why he changed the documentary." He feels bad.
Part of the documentary. He feels bad. Like a star.
He puts himself in there. That's like a hero trying to turn him in, trying to like.
Have you watched it already?
Did you watch it?
No, I already know.
Okay. So, yeah, at the very end, he does try to... He confronts Teddy. He gets Teddy to turn himself
but
in.
But Teddy won't. Though Teddy really doesn't want to.
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. Don't watch it.
I thought Dangerous Breed was...
Freestyles.
I thought it was good. I thought it was good because, you know what? Teddy Hart's kind of unknown, and it was cool to see fucking this, you know...
Yeah, I've always enjoyed
he's crazy, dude.
His craziness. I'm just a crazy person that likes craziness. So I've always enjoyed the craziness that he brought to that industry. Yeah. And... one of my favorite matches that I used to show everybody, like when I first got back into watching wrestling, was I saw him and Jack Evans from the Heavens, full sick.
Yeah.
I watched him and Teddy Hart have this match where it was just like, you know.
Was it the moonsaults?
It's just big spot after big spot
after
big spot.
Was it the moonsault after moonsault from the top of the
they
cage?
Did, no.
Okay, so that was on the documentary.
That was Ring of Heart.
Because he just kept doing the moonsaults, and then it wasn't planned. He just kept doing more.
Wait a second,
and more.
Wait a second.
And more.
After the match.
It was like during after.
He got pinned.
During and after, I
got
think.
Pinned and then went out after the match and started, like, didn't sell the finisher, went up and started throwing fucking flips. That's why he got beat up in the back.
Oh, yeah. They all just throw him out at the end.
But anyways, him and Jack Evans have a match, a different match, where they just fucking throw wild shit back and forth. And
crazy.
Not even like a – it's not even a wrestling match. It's just them just doing, like, the biggest things they could do. Like, every spot and then no sell, go to the top rope. Big fucking like pile driver off the
top
rope.
They said he was uncontrollable.
No sell. Fucking springboard. Fucking triple front flip. No sell.
When they say
get up.
When they say he's uncontrollable.
Untrainable. He's
untrainable
as well.
Because he was already trained. Obviously, would they just want him to what sell more? Like what do they want from
him? He won't listen. He won't follow directions.
I thought he always did.
He won't follow directions at all.
Not good matches. He just gets his shit in. You know what getting your shit in is?
Yeah, you get your tricks and you're done.
You got to go. You go in and you do all your biggest tricks and you try to look like a champ, no matter what the fucking match calls for. Sometimes it calls for you to go in there and just sell the whole time and make this guy look like the toughest motherfucker ever.
Yeah,
and just take punches. And make him look. That's what Shawn Michaels was so good at, right? Shawn Michaels was like, as much as people hated him
make
and he was
like
a dick, he would go
Shawn
in there.
Michaels,
he would go in there and make you look like the best. Like if you had a match with Shawn Michaels and he was going to put you over, he was going to make you look like the toughest motherfucker.
Have you ever met
that
man,
Shawn Michaels?
Yeah, you ever like got to like could be like, hey, Shawn, he turned around and like that. Yeah.
I sat next to his supposed wife.
Shawn.
Oh wow.
But you never hit him with the hey, Shawn. He turned around and you're like. Yeah, he's like a little dude.
So this man's bodyguard would be Teddy Hart. Who would your bodyguard have chosen?
My bodyguard would be Dead or Alive.
Dead or Alive.
Yeah, Dead or Alive.
Big Black.
Oh, dude, that'd
Damn,
be killed.
That's a big motherfucker.
That would be great.
That's a big motherfucker for
right?
sure.
You know what kind of made me sad, though?
What?
Is to find out that all the shit that they were doing was kind of a sale. You know, they're working it. You know, like when they
what
showed
do you mean? Hold
they
on, what do you mean?
Living together
like,
and shit.
No, none of that. But like when he would go to like skate and they'd go to places and security guards were kicking him out and when like Big Black would push him down and stuff like that, all that was in a work.
You didn't know that?
No, I kind of always thought, you know, maybe it was real. You know?
It's a wrestling
This is a reality show is. No reality TV is real.
Now you'll never. Now that you watch, you got a wrestling vibe in you. You'll never look at anything the
I
same.
Know,
again.
And that's what sucks.
Everything's a work.
Remember, I told you the punches on
everything's
Adam's
work.
Fucking pocket. No, that's fake. That's a work. Damn it! I always think that now.
That's the way it is. That's why when I watched Robin Big, I was like, oh, this is all work.
Yeah, but when Rob walked through the glass, that was real. You remember that episode?
Yeah.
He goes, "I bet you, if I just walk straight through it, my head down, it'll work."
All right, we're gonna get into a little bit of freestyle session. I don't know if the cameras are staying with us, but we appreciate you for staying with us. Here we go. I don't even know what this is, though. I just want to spit flows, get low. Some of these cats really understand that. Limbo isn't really going to get us past that. I'd like to pass back my glass hat. Some of these cats are on glass cracks. I give a fuck if you understand that. We only gonna be able to get back with fat calves as I spray across your face. And this is not complacent, this is the basement, chasing everything that I'm tracing. Sometimes I take it for what it ain't. And if I like this painting, then I gonna get it painting. I don't really like the spraying. I like the way that you say it, or maybe you can explain it. Or baby, I'm in the basement, or I'm only tracing everything that isn't really taking me back to amazement. Chasing all those feelings that I thought that I had. I kill it, I think that I'm mad. I really only want the bag, but some of these cats really want me to get the bag. I put on my mask just to make sure that I'm facing all the feelings that I thought that I was chasing. Now I'm taking it back to the point where this basement isn't enough for me or you. Now I hate it.
You know you hate.
You know you hate me.
Talk a lot, can't face it. What I'm saying is kind of different. Put your mask on, then I get the chase in. Catch me at the grocery store, holding them up. Shit is kind of different while I'm asking for bucks. I don't know what's going on, but I don't need a love. I'm heartless. What I'm saying is kind of different for love. I'm kind of holding it down from a different tempo. Shit is kind of different what I don't remember. I have to hold this shit down, call me a Kembo. But I'm not fighting in the backyard at all. It's simple. Do this shit big time. This shit is different when I rhyme. I grab microphones when I shine. But when I talk a lot of shit, everybody says lick my behind. I'm not ready for this, kinda just do it big time. Shit is kinda different when I'm spitting on a big rhyme. What I'm saying is that I ate a couple. Shit is kinda different, but I super doubled. I hold them down real quick, but I don't let them up. Shit is kinda getting quick, but I don't slip it up. I have to pull the knife out or straight and put it in your throat. Give me your money and everything you got in the coat.
Everything you got in your coat. And I don't really care when I come up for your throat. When I come through, when it's all about the sport. And I don't really care, come spin a different course. Trying to find the moment, I can't find it. I don't really care cause I can't rewind it. When I come through, time is going rewinding. And I can't find it cause I'm just relying on everything that ain't there. But I don't care when I got time to spare, but it ain't too rare. I don't really care cause I can't compare. Don't even know what I'm saying, so somebody else grab it, what I'm saying.
Hey yo, I want money, power, respect, motherfucker. If you wanna step with me, I'm gonna choke you out by the neck, motherfucker. Put you on the ground, stop your ass out, bitch. That's how you are, in the ground, on the ground, top of sound. This is me, freestyle, motherfucker, give you a pound on the ground. I don't give a fuck, like the UFC shit, my shit really sucks. I give a shout out, I got nothing else to say.
We give him a shout out, then I shout down. Sometimes I surround my sound with everybody that has been raised out of the underground. I found a new love for this. Maybe I'm loving it, or maybe I'm only stuck in the public eye. I give a fuck cause you know I love the sky. Whenever I'm looking at it on a November night, I wish that I wasn't even getting any closer. But sometimes I wish that I wasn't getting older. And every time that I grab the microphone, I fold it. Or maybe that's just you with a face on a poster. Yeah, I'm surrounded by death, so it's hard not to feel like I'm the one that's next. I grab the microphone and take another step. And sometimes I feel like I got nothing left in the breath and no tank. I give a fuck cause I give you no thanks. And I grab the mic and say fuck you.
Yo. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you. Turn my mic up.
Fuck you.
Give me a little mic. Turn up my snare. Just a little mic.
Turn up my snare.
Yo. I'm not really sleeping anymore. I woke up and I had to walk out the door. I understand what's going on, but won't ask for more. Motherfuckers talk a lot, but don't want to record. I have to sit up front while I'm straight staring. People talk a lot of shit, but I ain't caring. Might as well just do this every day and I'm parent. Yeah. If I have to say this shit, then everybody's believing. And I'm not ready to do this for any type of reason. I'm grabbing microphones, yeah, like it's the perfect season. If it's Christmas time, then I'm hanging the lights. If I'm at your house, then I'm banging your wife. Shit is kind of different now, but I say it for sure. What I'm saying's on the microphone, you better be sure. Because when I do this, you gonna listen. Shit is kind of different. Leave your ass in the kitchen. Make me a sandwich. Make sure it was turkey. Shit is kind of different, but it's getting early. Spitting on the mic, got a spit guard. Shit's going too deep, got a security guard. I'm not ready to go, but I'm kicking it out front. Renting the club, everybody wants to smoke the blunt, but I could quit the smoke. I don't understand, this ain't no joke.
Ain't no joke.
The beat's too hard, man. The beat makes me want to do crazy
shit.
Say no joke.
Say no joke.
Say no joke.
Say no joke. I'm gonna slit your throat. Say no joke. I'm gonna slit your throat.
This ain't no joke. I'm gonna slit your throat. And when I'm done, I'm gonna sniff some coke.
Yeah, sniff some coke. Sniff some coke. Yo, they escape on a boat. Yo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Escape on a boat. That's hard, dude.
Escape on a boat. Matter of fact, shut the fuck up on that note. Shut the fuck up. She's going alone.
If you ever escape on a boat, you know you're doing it in life. How'd you get away? We escaped on the boat, man. That shit's hard.
Boats and hoes.
All right, give me a cool hip hop beat. That was more like a crazy rap beat.
That was a little bit of a mafia.
Yeah,
style.
That was some wild shit.
That was a killer. That was a hitter. That was like a battle beat.
Yeah, that was wild.
I mean, we just gonna come jumping out into it straight into the fire.
Give it to me. Give me some
burning. Right. Burning motherfuckers alive.
Let's take it serious this time. Give me a little something.
A little serious.
There you go. It's hard to take a serious.
I'm curious.
I'm so curious. I'm so curious. I feel so delirious. Delirious. Why the fuck is this an experiment? An experiment. I can't trust this experience. Ooh. But sometimes I just want to talk to some lyricists.
Yeah, yeah.
And sometimes I just fear a hit. Yeah.
Ooh.
I clear my mind.
Yeah.
With the text.
Yeah.
Now I'm a deer in light.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I ain't fearing life.
Nope.
Yeah. Cause I'm near the light. Yep. And when it's shining, I can feel the motherfucking glowing.
Growing.
Brandon, that's double N-O-N. Show him no emotion. Holding it so close to. If you come closer, you can feel a clothespin near me. I am clearly above. Head and shoulders, some of these cats can't feel the love. Yeah, but the glove ain't fitting right. Yeah, cause I've been living a different life. I've been spitting on a different type of rhythm. Whenever they get in it, they see it for what it isn't. Or maybe I'm different distance away from the rest of these cats that be spitting that isn't. It's so tight, the way that I do it, fuck it. I don't need that mic, I just need the music. Yeah, I love the shit until the day that I die. And even when I'm fucking dead, I'ma be spitting some rhymes. Yeah. I mean,
spitting, hawking loogies. This shit is different. People all think they do me, but they don't. You couldn't put me down in caskets with 12 feet of dirt. What I'm saying is kind of different. Microphones will leave you hurt. I put the work in, but only work a 9-to-5. Shit is kind of different. Microphones will always stay alive. I wake up and I look out the rearview mirror. I understand what's going on, but on microphones I feel no fear. I stand up real quick, but I can't walk with these hurt knees. Shit is kind of different. On this mic you desert me. I desert real motherfuckers spitting chaos. Shit is kinda different. If I do this, I'm a deus. I shoot it out to everybody who's here spitting Christmas. But I'm spitting real lines, and your ass is spitting wishes. And I'm just only making sure that you hear all these bitches. Cause what I'm saying is that I'm not cleaning up these fucking dishes. I didn't make the mess, but I continue to make it. Shit is kinda different, but the beat didn't outlast it.
Didn't last it.
You good? They blasted. Get him. Go ahead, Siggy Sig. Hit him with the triple Sig.
Yo, how's it going, guys?
Yeah, shout out to the Milk people. Shout out to Oscar Goldman. Shout out to everybody out there.
Is this a song?
Yeah. That's all my shout outs, yo. Verse 1. This is me, JS3, formerly known. It's all good chilling in my homeboy's home. Got a clone, a lot of shit on my mind. You don't know what's going on. I got chromosomes misaligned. I don't know what's going on half the time. I try to write with a pen and paper and spit some rhymes, but it's all good, man. No memorization needed. It's all good, you know, man. The different shit I feeded. I mean, I fed off of. Different shit I did, different shit I said, like a shot off shotgun. I don't know what the fuck I'm saying, but it's all good. You know the rhymes coming out of my mouth, spraying. Got the spit guard, I need to borrow that shit. I need to go hard, motherfucker, I need someone that can spit. I'm a average lyricist, but I'm trying to be better. I want to get 10,000 hours out so I can be more clever.
Woo!
Whether or not the weather's gonna be cold or hot, it doesn't matter what's going on, my mind is gonna continue to rot. That's why I sought in the soil. This is me, man, get through all the bullshit and toil.
And I don't want no aluminum foil. I just want to make sure that I can recoil. Come back and give you something better than the before. And that's whenever I put it in the pot to boil. I ain't eating, I'm just trying to breathe in. And if I see you deceiving, then I'm leaving for the evening. I'm still beating, or maybe I'm bleeding. It doesn't really matter, cause be sick is here for the evening. And I ain't leaving, I'ma stay right here. I give a fuck, cause I ain't got no fucking light year fears. Or maybe that's just the way it isn't. I'm a little real, or maybe that's just me. I'ma give it to you like you never seen it before. I give a fuck, you should've never pushed record.
Woo!
Yeah, cause you know I spit a real pistol. Yeah, and I'm slicker than Bill Crystal. Fuck yeah.
Shout out Billy.
That's pretty sick.
Yeah, shout out to Billy.
He says that he's ripped it cleaner than you've ever seen. I'm not a criminal, but I've been jacking since 13. What I'm saying on this microphone, I grip it. Shit is kind of different, and you just rather sniff it. What I'm saying is hardcore now, and I'm not with it. Spit a couple rhymes out, and the flow gets shifted. To the left, to the right, I'm not ready to leave. I go out the exit door, and I'm spitting the breeze. And when I breathe it in, I only breathe success. And when I got these microphones, all you breathe is cess. I understand what's going on, but I won't take the less. I always take the best route for me, and if that has to be the best, then I take it.
Shit is different, won't make it. Drink Canadian whiskey until you're buck naked. What I'm saying is on this microphone, this shit gets perfect. I do this all day, but I spit like a serpent. I'm not hissing on no microphone, I'm getting my scales. Shit is kinda different, might as well just pass me the bail so I can get you out on the road. And shit is different on this microphone, I leave you exposed. I switch it up real quick like I'm stopping some flows. I don't know what's going on, but I'll put it in nose. I have to put my nose to the grind surface and sniff it. Shit is kinda fucking different when I'm ripping, I spit it. If I have to do this shit, then no, it's always not written. I'm not know what I'm saying now, so I continue spitting. Pass off the microphone, tell my boy to get it.
Yo, get it? I'm gonna spit it. This is me, motherfucker. Ain't no quitting it. I just punched in. I'm on the clock. This is me representing hip-hop, because I'm never gonna stop. Tick-tock, like the album drops. Oscar Goldman. What's going on, man? I can't wait to see you, man. Okay, I'll see you in about an hour or two. What's going on? I'm gonna spit a verse or three for you. Woo! Until then, this is me. I spent way too much time sitting on my ass, but it's all good. I'm gonna come back with a sick rhyme, a new design, something I've contracted in my mind. Different shit is going on. I don't know what the fuck is going on, but I'm gonna keep going on, because I'm gonna stretch and yawn. Yeah. Motherfucker, this is how I go on and on. I'm going on infinity, like I'm spinning in circles. What's going on with you, motherfucker? I'm jacking off and I might hurt you.
What's going on? I'm rare like filet mignon. Your motherfuckers are also wrong. I wish that you would get in a circle and sing every one of my songs, but you probably wouldn't, you couldn't if you tried it. That's alright, cause I'm opening up your eyelids. See, I dot my I's and cross my T's. Y'all motherfuckers finna fuck with me, I'm Socrates. On another level, I'm way different. It doesn't really matter about the way that you spit it, I don't listen. Every time you rap, I turn my back. I'd rather turn it off, but I couldn't, cause in fact the...
This is not Cisco and Ebert. This is Cisco the Dragon and Ebert.
I'm Cisco the Dragon, and that's my boy Ebert.
Yes, we here. We here. Ebert would be a hard-ass name.
Ebert.
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 He's a rap group, Cisco and Ebert.
Hell yeah. critiquing niggas.
Realize.
Cisco and Ebert. Get him, realize. Open this one up for us.
Yo. I'm something like Cisco and Ebert. Shut the fuck up, open your ears, cause you're the receiver.
Woo!
I don't really care, you can perceive me how you wanna perceive me. Cause when I'm moving, better believe I'm moving through the world greasy. I'm slippery, you can't catch my ass cause I'm moving. You don't understand cause I'm the teacher and you're the student. Woo! When the lines ain't congruent, I make them perpendicular. When I hit you, man, I'm killing your mom vehicular. Manslaughter was the case that they gave me, I'm rare. And I don't really care if I spit shit, I ain't cut out of spare. So I move quickly, move spread quick like a rash. And I don't really care, but I believe I'm all about my cash. I had to dash quick once when I was running from the cops. This shit wasn't funny, man. I had a pocket full of rocks. I had a knife in my pocket. I tossed that shit, then I rocked over the fucking fence. And I didn't care, man. The shit was dense. The situation got hairy. The situation was scary. I didn't really care because I moved quick and they were fearing me. They were scared of me. I grabbed the gun and I shoot it. I don't really care because, like I said, I'm the teacher. You're the student, so shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up. Just to get myself clear, the man makes judgeable statements from the rear. I understand what's going on, but on microphones, I'm deaf to it. What I'm saying is kind of different. You a deaf student.
Yeah.
So I speak to you with fingers. What I'm saying is kind of different. Call out Cisco and Ebert. I'm not ready to do this shit unless we're getting close to it. I critique your rhymes and your straight rhyme fluid. And I don't know if I have to say this, but you need it. I do this all day while other cats are getting weeded. I'm not sitting down and continuously just rhyming. I do this every day and I spit it with perfect timing.
And when he's talking about cats getting weeded, I'm that cat and you better believe it. Woo! I'm eating everything that you see and I put it in sequence. God damn it, you gotta know that I'm dreaming. I mean, living the life I couldn't think I could. Now I'm here like I'm right on my wood. Maybe you don't understand exactly what I've been. That's okay, cause you don't understand I've been overlooked. Took me a little bit longer, but that's alright, I fight back for all my honor. See my father, he might already be a goner, but I'm still right here living my life on earth. Some of these motherfuckers don't know I am proper, and every motherfucker wants to get lost like they fostered kids. Motherfuckers can't fuck with this, so I stay stuck in this like I love this bitch with all of my heart and shit. Sometimes this artist gets stuck in the garbage again. Maybe this garden might get a little bit more starter. Maybe that's just me trying to get a little farther with this life that I've been living in my mind again. Open up your mind just so I can pry this shit out. I've been eating perfectly fine, but I ain't done eating cause I need it right now.
Yo, rocks in my socks. Fucking pocket full of chips.
My man. Got the open lines on top.
Bump that shit in the whip. Back in the day, shout out to 3-6 Mafia. Sometimes I just don't know what to say. Turn my snare up. I can barely hear myself. Fucking rhyme. What's going on, man? I need to bust a new rhyme. Okay, what's going on with my mind? I don't know. So I'm going to sit back and just sit back slow.
You make me sick. I want to vomit. You're the type of cat to like his own fucking comments. I guess I'm wrong for that. What I'm saying is kind of different. Get an aluminum bat. Bust him open like I'm robbing the pizza man. Shit is kind of different. I guess you the freestyling man.
I'm the ice cream man.
I guess you can talk through a can. Put one can to your ear and put it to your mouth and you can hear everything you can.
With a string.
Yeah, with a string.
With the motherfucking string.
You doing one more beat or is that
one
it?
One more, that's it. All
right.
That's the last one.
Yeah, you're hanging by a string.
Open this one up. Open this one up.
Your mother this ding-a-ling.
It's too short. It's too short. Give us a good one. Give us a good one. Give us a
longer one.
Give us a long one.
You're the longer one. Oh, Addy.
I thought that was part of the ad for a second. I go, geez, it sounds fucking like an ad. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, ad's coming again. Hold on.
Oh, man. I was ready for Chinese water torture.
Talk about what you're going to talk about. You need a subject. You want a word. You want
what you need?
Waterfall.
Oh, no. Whatever you go, I just kind of go off the beat. If the beat seems like a Chinese fucking water torture, then we'll go
that's
there.
Start talking about Chinese water torture.
If you want to go, I'll start it up.
Yeah, drop one at a time.
Let me get some chicken cot paws, a couple of broccoli ragoons. What I'm saying is kind of different. I'm looking towards the moon. Karate chops are coming at your neck. Give you a deadly touch and put you next. I guess I know the touch of death. What I'm saying is more hardcore when I smell your breath. If I have to do this microphone, I'll touch your chest. Ching chong Chinaman, I'll serve you a breast. I'm not ready for this, but I'm cooking some dog. I got some cat soup out and I'm cooking for frogs. I don't know what's going on, but I'm ripping for log. I go, King Tom, what I really, really want? I'm not ready to spit this, let you gripping. What I'm saying is hardcore now, I guess you're spitting. Come down to where? Lodi Avenue. Meet yourself down, get some Chinese food.
Shout out to Chop Chop.
Shout out to Chop Chop. Loretta.
Shout out to Ming Sing.
Yeah, Ming Sing.
Yes, sir.
Red Turn door, it around. Red door. I can't
Shout out
burn
to
it
Dragon
down.
Light Deli.
Try yes, to figure sir. Out where the verse is now. I'm just trying to make sure it's underground. I don't even know how to feel that. I can't follow it, so I kill it back. Try to understand why I'm stealing rap. But maybe I'm just trying to understand how I feel about that. It's not really, really getting real. I just open up my mind so I know the deal. I ain't got time to kill, so I got time to steal. So I'm putting inside a bill and trying to seal it. Every time it's done, but maybe that's mine. It doesn't really matter because I can't push rewind. And sometimes I used to like the 95, but 97's looking a little better in my mind. I wish that I could get to 2005. And now I'm just trying to climb this mountain alive. I wish that I could catch my breath. And I don't know what to do with my next step, so I take them and I try not to trip. And sometimes I'm tripping, sometimes I listen, sometimes I'm different, sometimes I'm distant. Sometimes I wish that this isn't really what it really turned to be. Or maybe that's me trying to burn the free. I think that you know, I just burn bridges so I can't go where others go when I can't expose. I think I explode, maybe that's just me flowing. I don't give a fuck because I know where I'm going. Really ain't that pump whenever I sit and shiver. Sometimes they just like to listen to this. I'm like a kid,
I'll give you a chorus.
Don't really know what to do with it. I don't give a fuck, now the music moves. I just want to move with you so you feel how I move the room. Wax on, wax off. Wax on, wax off. Wax on, wax off. Wax on, wax off. You don't want to fucking crank kick. You don't want to fucking crank kick. Kick it with a fucking karate kid. Wax on, wax off, you bitch.
I just got sweet chin music. I just got sweet chin music.
Jesus.
I just got sweet chin music.
That's enough to get you canceled.
I just got sweet chin music.
That's enough to get you canceled. Hey. R.I.P. to Bruce Lee.
God, hey. What the fuck was that about?
We just jumping.
Jesus, you're just killing everybody.
You sucker. I'm jumping in.
We were pretending and you just go ahead and throw Bruce Lee in this.
I'm jumping into the newest
what
news.
What Bruce Lee do
Hold
to
on,
you?
No,
I know.
The newest news.
Who are you hurt by?
Bruce Lee's here in the
Bruce,
news again?
Bruce Lee, his death has now contributed to drinking too much water as of late.
Yeah, I've heard
a
that.
New
I've
study,
heard that.
Yeah, a new
I've heard
study. That. What do you think about that? Do you think Bruce Lee really died of drinking too much water?
Maybe he was taking a lot of ecstasy.
I mean.
Maybe.
Well,
have you ever heard about the girl
in Sacramento, the Sacramento radio station that was doing the Wee for Weed.
Yeah, the water, the water challenge.
Oh. Yeah, they were drinking as much water as you can, and you couldn't take a piss. And if the person that didn't take a, or the person that lasted the longest without peeing would get a Wee system. And this is when Wees were really hard to get.
Yeah, like, yeah. Christmas special. Yeah.
And so this mom did it, and she drank all this fucking water.
How much?
She won the Wee, like fucking Alhambra thing of water, bro.
No.
She won the Wee, but she went home, and she died later because her organs, she drowned her organs, basically.
Good God.
Oh, my God.
Body can only... You can only drink so much water that your body absorbs and digests, right? Your body has to use that water.
Let's
and
be
has
honest.
To go though. Somewhere. If it doesn't, then it just floods.
How much water do you think you drink a day? Water bottle wise.
A lot.
I drink about five water bottles a day, maybe six.
Five small little ones or whatever?
No, they're the good normal size, like these.
So you five see these?
Six, yeah.
I have like four.
What is this?
I have
12, I think.
I have three that are about this size, and then one big one, my one big one. I drink 20. Those every day. There's four of them.
So how many ounces do you think you're fucking with then?
As close to a gallon, probably.
How much is like five of these? Four or five of these?
You need to have about a gallon or, you know, if you're active and shit.
Yeah.
I definitely don't drink enough water 36, myself.
36, maybe five of them on a good
but
day.
But don't drink too much water because you will die.
I drink about four or five of them. I think that's pretty decent.
Bruce Lee had no water weight. That
how about
man
you?
Was shredded to the bone.
How
I don't think he was drinking any water.
How much water do you think you drink a day?
Probably about that.
Four or five
water bottles.
It's pretty simple to drink four or five. I think, you know, it's a couple hours you have one, a couple hours of another, you know, a couple hours of another. Mm-hmm. You're not too bad. How about you, Sig? How many think you hitting?
I mean, not a full gallon, but probably under that. Like, say, 3/4 of a gallon.
I'd say so, too. That sounds like a pretty normal. I think if you're
hitting
a gallon, you're doing your job. But if you're right underneath it, I mean, you're going to get by. You're getting by.
Yeah, that fool looks like he doesn't drink any water.
Yeah, no, he was pretty fucking shredded.
Bruce Lee didn't.
He looks like he has no water on him.
Let me see the man. Give me the scar picture. I want the one with the scratch on the chest. You got the scratch on the chest, Lee?
I mean, I do. No,
that's a good one.
But I'll show you this one. This is a classic Bruce Lee picture.
Classic Bruce.
Favorite martial artist of all time?
Chuck Norris or Bruce Lee?
Jackie Chan.
I like Bruce
Jackie
Lee.
Chan.
Jackie Chan.
I like
Bruce
Jackie
Lee.
Chan. I like Jet Li too.
That's a bad motherfucker.
He's a bad motherfucker right there. Shout out to Alex Cousin.
Jet Li, what happened?
Shout out to Alex Cousin.
What happened to
Bruce
motherfucker? What happened to Jet Li? Jet Li kind of fell off.
I just think he's kind of just maybe realized how the shit was going. They were using him for more than his talents. You know
what do you mean?
I feel like they weren't using him for his acting abilities. It's more of his talents as in like karate, like tricks and this and that.
Uh-huh.
And I think a lot of people were against that. Like Bruce wasn't. So a lot of people give Bruce Lee shit about like doing a lot of fake shit in movies for that Chinese like kind of like, you know, way of this does this and this does this and this.
It's wrestlinged up.
Yeah.
Like pro-wrestlinged up.
But he took a lot of shit for that. You know what I mean? You know it. And he tried to make a school where he was teaching people that weren't Japanese or Chinese karate and shit like that, and they weren't the Chinese people that would teach that were like, nah, this is strictly for us, this is this and this and that. He was an innovator, don't get me wrong, of his time, a very big innovator.
Yeah.
But they said he also kind of went against the grain when it came to showing people ways of the dragon.
That.
You know what I mean?
I can see that.
You know what I'm saying though, right?
Wait,
top foreigners fucking taekwondo and
shit. Yeah, that's what I mean. So he did a lot of shit that you know was ahead of its time because his wife was white.
Favorite ninja movie of all time.
You know what
time.
I mean? And his son, I hate to say,
Three Ninjas?
Ninja Turtles?
Were the Lees cursed?
Yeah, Brendan Lee
The Crow.
The whole thing with the Crow is crazy.
So were the Lees cursed?
You know,
Bloodsport.
Yeah, he got Alec Baldwin on set.
Yeah, he did. He was the first of the kind.
He got the Alec Baldwin.
He was the first Alec Baldwin.
Brandon
out
Lee?
There.
Yeah, Brandon Lee. Yeah, Brandon Lee got shot and killed a prop gun.
Jumping on the table. Someone put a real gun.
Somebody set his ass.
People think it's inside.
And in their defense, they say that everybody that has a prop gun, they shoot real blanks. They shoot bullets. It's a real gun. It's never a fake gun because you need the real gun to strike the bullet. So they say it's like that.
That's very sketchy.
You shooting blanks?
Very sketchy.
You shooting blanks? Shit. With my age, I'll shoot blanks now. Well, I don't want anything.
Someone in this room
is
bound to shoot a blank on this one. We got song picks?
Yeah, I got a song pick.
Song picks.
The motherfucking week.
I'm going first.
Okay, I'll give you
always,
a track next.
Always. I never
the
go
man always goes first.
I never go first. I'm going first. We're going Mac Miller. We're going Funeral.
Schmack Miller.
Off of the Faces. You know, this is our favorite, or at least me and Matt's favorite.
Oh, yeah, I love this fucking
Schmack
album.
Schmack Miller. Schnapp Simpson.
But this is Funeral off of that album.
Yeah.
Let me ask you, before you start the song, pause it real quick.
Turn
off
my headphones.
Just real quick. How do you feel about bands that have a song out for years and they finally bring it out as a music video? Is it even respectable anymore?
Yeah.
Do you like that?
Yeah.
Sublime just did that.
Wait, how old was the song?
The song is by Bradley himself, and it's called.
You don't like that?
No, I love it. That's what made Ella cool. Waiting for My Ruka.
It's a song we've never heard?
No, we've all heard the song. Waiting for My Ruka has been on fucking 40 Ounces of Freedom and like the Romeo CD he had and shit like that. It's been out for a long, long time. I've heard it hundreds of times. But it's just cool that they made a music video. I thought it was
that?
Okay. No, I'm not going to play that.
People do that.
I just want to know how you feel about that.
That's interesting.
You think that's a good deal? That they? I mean, how come Slug doesn't do that?
I don't dislike it. I don't dislike it.
What did Slug go back and fucking put out I Was Santa Claus video?
He brought an old track back on a new album.
Come on. That album's old, though. Continental. Yeah, that song's old. That album's old, though, now. Now you think about it. That's like a 15-year-old album now.
All right. Here we go.
Give it to me.
Mac Miller. Funeral. Yeah. Max Schmiller with Schmunel. This music go with my funeral. Yeah. Yeah. Music go with my funeral.
Yeah. Sit. Said I was raised inside this gritty city. Riding through, you probably miss me. My bicycle fell, I hit the road, the mailman almost hit me. All these sins were more than shitty. I just pray the Lord forgive me. Doing drugs is just a war with boredom, but they sure to get me. My side bitch is sorta pretty, but she got enormous titties. Know I'm worth a fortune, she just want a brand new Porsche Bentley. Had a few abortions, unfortunately I forced them. Lord knows I'll turn a child to an orphan when I'm torn. I'm more than what I think of myself. I really have to be, sit at home and drink by myself. My thoughts harassing me, actually as a matter of fact, she ain't getting back to me. Ashamed that my tragedy, my masterpiece, yeah.
So trapped true.
Inside these dreams of mine.
His tragedy is a masterpiece.
It's the best.
Trying to get some peace of mind.
This is his best album.
I've been trapped inside of dreams of mine, so you'll never get a peace of mind.
No, his death is his best masterpiece, and he knew that. He was calling it a shot before he shot it.
You think so?
My tragedy will... This is called Funeral.
I know.
This song's called
Funeral. But do you feel like...
I'm saying it's beautiful, my tragedy.
And he even says in this album, you can find me OD'd on my couch. And that's where they found him. Oh, they found him by his bed in a praying position. It's crazy, huh? Party like it's the last day of your life.
Yeah. Yeah, see we swallowed in this web of lies. Never try to exercise. It used to be a fantasy, but now I guess it's televised. I heard the legends never die. Oh, this lonely hell of mine. There never was a better time to better myself. Forever I melt and float away like waves in the ocean. Stare inside of heaven's eyes, the gates will never open. I'm smoking on this field of hope, waiting till my deal gets closed. I keep getting hotter, but all I seem to feel is cold. 22 don't feel so old. But I think I'm 82.
Mean to Mac tell me Miller with Funeral.
Hell yeah, dude. That
was good. Something beautiful.
I'm going to give you a track that I was speaking about earlier.
Yeah, let's go. Sick.
Give me Vinnie Paz featuring Method Man.
Oh, that's good.
I called it the wrong name earlier. It's called Invisible Ether. So Invisible Ether, Vinnie Paz featuring the M-E-T-H-O-D man from the Wu-Tang
Clan. The Method Man.
Or now known as the Wu-Tang Clique.
Nice.
The Klan has been canceled.
Because you know why? They don't want to be associated with the Klan.
I mean, hey, Kanye's out there, you know, spitting out this and that about the Klan.
Do you stop listening to Kanye songs?
I think I'm done with Kanye.
I mean, do you not have one?
But I want to know what the fuck's going on.
You weren't done with Kanye before?
I'm not saying
I've been telling this guy for years
now. This is what I say about Kanye. Kanye has a lot of mental issues, and he's clearly... He has problems, and
what
he just
were you
always
listening
tweeting
to
and talking.
Of Kanye before
he's out in the public.
You
want to
hear what I could tell you?
I like his old classic music.
Oh, like that First Graduation album.
Yeah, those ones.
And then,
yeah, man, College Dropout, all that shit. Like those are good.
Yeah, for sure.
Those are good albums, bro.
My favorite song Vinny though, Paz, by him at all. Father Stretch.
This
my
is
hand.
This is Vinny Paz featuring Method Man. Invisible Ether. Wu-Tang forever. Filling it in. And the day. You heard? Wu-Tang forever. This is what I do in my sleep, man. So here we go. Official pistol and all that. Go, go, go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I say, lights, camera, action, and back to clean up the act again. Cashing in, kinda like Apple Pay, they tapping in. It take two, you not Rob Bass Clown, you capping it. Roger that, I'm in Rob's place now. What's happening? Statin' in the building, ain't no accident. We might take a knee, aiming Kaepernick. I'm dope, but I ain't trafficking. Nah, ain't no comparison. Babbling rappers, imagining they battling Eminem, using them bars, embarrassing. Every time I ate, I turn my passion into passionate. You hazardous, and half of my mob deep ain't having it. Master this music. I ain't Harriet,
But still I took the underground road with no swing low, sweet chariots. It's so amazing, I've graced many occasions.
Killing. That's a sick, like he's killing. Salad and raisins.
He's hard. In your mouth, my
foul's flagrant. That's why I always say he's my favorite move.
He's hard. Yeah.
Not only that, he's entertaining. He has charisma.
Yeah, for sure.
How high is a Christmas movie?
Yeah!
No?
Vinnie Paz! Vinnie Paz, daddy!
Trees in there.
Coming at ya! Jedi Mons!
Yeah! I will torture like Rebecca. 45 with me, like me Corey against a panker. Side pop a robber and the shorty speaking vanker. Motherfucker goof again, I thought he was a manga. Fucking goofball. Magazines that contain 80. Motherfuckers really is goofy, but play crazy. Fucking dickhead. I kill it will and you can't fade me. Shot fire at you, I slap you like Wayne Brady. That's a shoddy and it's many more. A golden key can open any door. Broken ass, woofer in a speaker. Tambourine man, and he cooking in the beaker. The temperature hot and it's too humid. I don't like the way that you talk and you move stupid. The 38,
let it run.
You made your bed, you gotta lie in
it.
Just a Italian stallion.
Pennsylvania.
Shout out to Vinnie Paz.
Invisible Ether. Vinnie Paz with your boy Method Man.
The man's got a lot of albums.
I know Yamas is working over there. He can't find anything. He's got to tickle his boyfriend's butt.
You got to type in dot L loves. Mama J,
whisker, you tickle a good butthole. That whiskers you got on you.
What do you got?
Oh, if we're gonna do an old school, you know, something I, you know, I,
what you got?
I could play.
Just play a fucking all right, song. All right,
how about this?
Play Suicide Boys and let's get it over. All right, with.
Suicide Boys, give me O Panna. O P A N A.
Yeah. What album was that from?
O-P-N-A. That's from fucking yeah. That's from it's the Gray album with all
this
the
is a very
it's called the Gray album.
Very sample.
It's called the Gray
it's
album.
It's a very sample 3-6 track. Yes. I want to say this
yes.
one.
Yes. I was looking for a good Trip 6. Classic.
I knew you were looking for some suit.
I got you.
The sample's hard as fuck.
Super hard.
Hit the blunt. Hit the blunt.
Turning this up louder, but you can do more than that. Throw some juice in there.
Wake up with the active face. Pop two pills with Gatorade. Round my neck, yeah, Gator face. Might pop your mom on a later day, but I don't know. Young slow, kinda go with the flow. Bring her home backstage. She'll tell me everything you know about life, then I bounce. Rising, hitting hard, feeling fucking sick. How the fuck I have it now? Just to balance it out. We be backing out. We be backing out. All the fucking people, I think we be getting out. Grass is always greener when the gravy like a grouse. We be loving out. And now that it's cracking up, you can let the curtains down now. Yeah.
I just bought 10 Roxy's, called a body dinner. Chronic place with something, I'm like, fuck it, let me. Rolling down your block, it ain't shit for the center. Told that bitch, get out my ear, she need a chili. Xanax bars up in my drink before I pour them. We never fuck with you, fuck boy, don't act like you can. Take that motherfucking bed upside your skull. So full of them drugs, I might throw up. I knew I shouldn't
have hit the blunt. I like how he does that. He does it so perfect with the crusher that's when they hit the blunt. That's perfect.
Hit the blunt.
That song
hit
dope.
The blunt.
Yeah, Suicide Boys upon it.
What makes it tighter in the back of the van the whole time? In the van, just chilling. Like, come on. That's so sick.
They look like they're having no fun, though.
They're having a blast.
No. But they look so fucked up and they're nodding off and they're like,
yeah, they are gonzo.
That's what they want to look like for that video, too.
That's
though.
What they
that's
were.
Exactly
for
what
sure.
I know they were. But you know that feeling they're having right there? It's not fun. And if you were in the back of a car.
Oh, yeah, it's even worse. You're like, I want to get the fuck out, stretch my legs. I just want to get the fuck out of here.
Car sick.
Yeah.
All off of Oxy and Xanax bars and shit.
It's the blunt.
Hey,
it's the blunt.
That song's so fucking
I knew I shouldn't
it'll,
hit
it'll
the
always
blunt.
Be one of my favorite Suicide Boy songs, for sure.
All right, Steve.
What you got
the motherfucking week?
Over there. Nothing.
God damn it.
Nothing.
Say a song.
You got something. Give us something.
You know a song.
We want something.
Anti-con.
Hit the blunt.
Mother
hit
of invention.
The blunt.
Mother of invention.
Deep puddle dynamics.
Hell yeah. Hey, shout out to Dose One, who is going to be coming on the podcast probably sometime next month. So be looking out for that one. Hit the blunt. Hit the blunt.
Joey Badass Unorthodox.
There you go. Okay, let me ask you this, though. Does that song hold up or what?
What, Opana?
Yeah.
It's a good song.
It's a good hit. It's a good hit.
It's the beat, though. It's the beat that really makes it, I feel like, man.
That's pretty sick.
Okay? That beat makes it. Without that beat.
Hey, Joey Badass is, what was his homie's name that was the fucking dope one in the group that I liked that died, that jumped off the roof?
I can't even think. You put me on the spot.
God damn it. And he was the one that I liked that was in that group.
No, he was bad as fuck. I can't think of his name.
Oh, my God, dude.
I'm blanking.
Hang on. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But they were fucking hard. Anyways, Joey Badass, Unorthodox. Song picks. Oh, you're
Joey Badass.
Is
motherfucking way. Shout out to Joey Badass. Where's he from? He's from the East Coast, right?
From Newark. Newark.
York. Is he from Brooklyn or?
From Newark. I think so. What was that fool's name?
The Badass.
N-A-W-O-R-K from Newark.
His friend that died.
Hit the blue.
Yeah.
Hit the blue.
Right when you say it, I'm gonna be like, yeah, fucking.
Where is Joey Badass from? Is he Newark? Is it Newark?
Hit the boot. He's from Brooklyn.
Close to Newark.
What's his
Brooklyn.
Crew?
Brooklyn.
Look up his crew.
Capital
Stees.
Yeah.
And that fool was sick.
Cap Stees.
Cap Stees.
Capital Stees was tight as fuck.
That song's so fucking hard, though. Good pick. I'm not sure if anybody's ever picked this as their song.
Everybody
pick.
Love him.
Very good.
On the regular. Looking at popular colored faces, observing what my brother's faces, and all races, lost to generations, avoid hatred, see what your eyes dilated for the sake of the G's, but keep it sacred, G, fuck a rat race, we take the cheese, Jack Cheddar from the make-believe, break the trees on the ACD, rocking the red and black lumberjack faithfully, I'm a Brooklyn nigga, basically, I grind with the grimiest, learn how to eat in the jungle full of hyenas and vultures, don't worry what a verse will cost ya,
bro, era, just
remember. Who taught ya? I'm a Spartan off unorthodox. Won't sign to no major, no wager. Less than the 3 million offer. Off the top, I'll be in a box when my coffin drops. Why I settle for an office spot? Niggas don't always make it off the block. Lest they extort rocks to support the cops. They still snitching. Let me guess, that's shenanigan. Leave him shook where he's standing and quit the shenanigans. Have you panicking? Induce damages till you're vanishing. Words are told probably resort autopsy examining. This is for my real hip hop fans.
That reminds me of. When Chris D'Elia did the Eminem, I manage the damage,
oh,
I manage,
yeah.
Hit him with the advantage, or manage, go make you be amateur.
He did
amateur, damage, damage.
What's his name?
Terminate damage, maybe get banned.
What's his name? Does it the best, though?
Windex.
Lil Windex.
I found out the stairs and I broke my elbow.
Lil Windex?
Lil Windex does Eminem the best.
Yeah, they call me Lil Windex.
Hard on. No, that fool. We'll go into that. That's Joey Badass with Unorthodox.
Explain to these people who Lil Windex really is.
No, we found out about Lil Windex.
Lil Windex, motherfucker.
So we were watching.
Yeah, he's hard like that. He's hard like that, but he's really not, though. It's all character.
We watched this full. We were watching this full DX. What was it? DKG or DX?
DTG.
DTG. And we were like, oh, that fool's tight. And then all of a sudden we saw this full Lil Windex. We're like, hey, they look like the same person, you know?
Yeah.
So we did a little bit of digging, and we were like, wait a second. This fool just spits like really
hip-hop
shit.
Show him the real guy,
shit.
And I'll show him who Lil Windex looks like.
Really
Lil
Windex. He throws out this Lil Windex character and gets like millions and millions of views.
And the other one, he gets no views. And
it's
his real person.
But it's really cool. Like, it's dope-ass fucking. Okay, no. Let's just watch this song. He tells the story right
this
here.
Lil Windex.
Damn, okay.
And this one gets all the views, and his real persona gets no
none of
views.
It. Okay,
yeah.
Let's just watch this.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
This is a good one.
Here's for all the viewers out there to see the transition of the man.
It's awesome. It's awesome.
No, let's watch this.
Oh, you got it going on
I got
up there.
Something. I got
okay,
something.
Okay, got it.
It's fucking awesome, dude. And he's always wearing that fluffy, that puffy-ass fucking North Face old school shit that's like bright blue and fucking the teal color. And shit. Yeah. He looks tight. I give it up.
It's funny.
Yeah, so this right here is a song. I mean, I don't know why we're doing this, but we're going to do it. We've done this before.
Mercules?
Yeah, hopefully you don't get canceled for this one.
It's his homie.
We got shout-outs from Lil Windex.
So basically, this is just telling a story about why he does Lil Windex, and it's him next to Lil Windex.
Hey. All right, yeah, I'm back. Cause people decided to act like I cannot rap, but well, I'm tired of that, and I'm about to snap. Yeah, find me the gas, I'll fire the matches, I'll light up a trap. You thought I was gone, you're honestly wrong. I am the one making all of the songs. Only problem that's drawn, if the costume ain't on, then I'm not what they want. But I gotta be calm and play it by ear. I fucked around once and I made a career. Now every time I see my face in the mirror, I don't feel the same, like I'm caged out of fear. If I run, I will fail, been stuck in a jail. I'm trying to break free, but keep tucking my tail. And right now people buying my stuff by the pails, and switching the product might fuck up the sales. It made me increase. I've been waking, been sleeping, it ain't like I'm leaving, just changing the seasons. I love all my fans, they're merely the reason I am where I am, and my gang has been eating. I'll never mistreat them, that's not how it works. We're family now, I put all of y'all first. But I'm tired of watching them fall for the person I'm not. So before this, I hollered that Merc and said, man, I just need to be me again, man. I'm fucking losing it. It's like I'm stuck in this box. He told me, well, if that's how I feel, well then.
You gotta show a little Windex song after this.
The fool just does a little Windex on his own thing and he's hella popular.
I just wanna be me again. Fuck all the cash and the women, the factors I've been in.
And this fool gets no plays compared to Lil Windex.
He's actually pretty high.
But I gotta be thankful because of the traction it's given me. None of this shit would've happened without both the glasses and wig and just added the imagery. That was my vision, see? It was done from the start. Look stupid and dumb down the bars. Now run for the stars.
And this is the fool that does Eminem now.
Just give him a taste. He's hella Eminem shit.
Yeah, it blows up.
Throw that shit in your face. Anything that you suffer that isn't the case. You got talent and just gotta figure a way out to use it. Stupid how much of a joke that the industry is. Look who they're promoting to millions of kids. Bunch of dudes that are doped up.
Alright, let's see Lil Windex.
Alright, put the dope Lil Windex on. Lil Windex is hard. He's spraying.
Yeah, he's playing
everywhere. He's doing his life. He's killing. Everyone loves it.
How many plays do you think the first one?
Millions. Let's see it. Fucking 14 million. Give me that one. Clean it up. It was already hurting him in the streets.
Oh, damn.
Lil Windex don't fuck around. I already can't take this nigga serious. Yeah,
I make these I make these songs in 10 minutes.
Hurt. Yeah. I'm sure he does. His laugh? Yeah, it's the laugh, too.
I'm on the block with a couple goons. Couple blocks, couple knots. Who the fuck are you?
The Windex?
Everyone's praying.
Pouring lean in my double cup. Got me feeling hella fitted. Tell it fuck me up. Then I'm twisting up a swisher. Bitch, I am my boss in case you didn't get the picture. Money, 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 money. It's all I ever care about, I swear it isn't funny. If you cross me, you get shot down. Flesh rip when it lit up with a hot round. Pop out, click, clack, many shit whack. Everywhere I go, I always got a thick stack. Lil Windex, I know you gon' remember me. If you don't like me, then I guess you're not my enemy.
Hard though. It's a hard jacket.
The beat's hard too.
Said I'm cleaning it up.
I'm cleaning it up. The Eminem
falling down the stairs
was the funny
one. The one with this kid's pretty funny. He's in the room. He's telling him to clean up his room, and he's like, "I shouldn't be telling you to clean up your room."
Ah, kids, you like shit. I just tripped and fell. This isn't well, and I hit my hell, bro. But no one was around, though. That's good, because that would have been embarrassing. For the second time this week, barreling down the stairs again.
That was crazy.
Oh, you call him Everlyn?
Play the one with him and his son, or he's telling him to clean the room. Or he's telling him to clean the room up.
If Eminem had an energy drink.
Oh, Jesus.
That's going to row.
You know what rhymes with Mariah's a known liar? I don't really know, because I am just so tired. This shit better work. Okay, now I got some energy. I feel like there's 10 of me like centuries, and I can run tremendous feet from Beverly to Tennessee, stretch a breeze, and then repeat my sensory is better than it's ever been. An entity is enemy, man.
You shut the fuck up.
Fill him with a penman, eliminate him. Other words, I'm intimate him. I don't want to put him in a name.
That's the one, I think. Oh, no, wait, that's not it.
Yo, listen to this song, man.
Have
you
seen
this?
That fool looks like
triple extension.
Damn. Maybe I should do a 20. Maybe I should break that 20, do a 10. Maybe I should break that 10, do a 5. Then if it gets live, do a 5 again. If he held his tongue on that live, he'd be alive again. Damn. My uncle
Drake, you know why that happened, though.
Because Drake was talking shit on Drake.
Drake stole his whole fucking, stole his whole tempo to a song.
Look at 10 plus 10 is 5. XXXX.
And if he held your shit, if he held his tongue on that live, he'd be alive again.
No, but
did Drake kill that fool? Or Drake had him kill?
No, they said that. I remember everyone said that. Yeah, that Drake, was behind his murder. But that's all hearsay. That's all bullshit. It was just kind of like a, it was a fake little floater that people were saying because of that. Yeah, come on.
You don't think you could have somebody killed? That fool has millions.
I think he has
billions.
He can do whatever he wants.
I don't think he's that crazy enough to do it.
Yeah, I don't think he cares enough.
He ain't a
thug. I don't think he cares enough. He's
he don't
want to
kill nobody.
That guy ain't taking his spotlight away.
Yeah, he was handicapped on the grass. He shot and killed.
But you did hear though that that fool said that Drake took his whole cadence to a song and turned around and did his own thing.
Drake was making him look like a bitch.
Yeah. Okay, I didn't know you were such a Drake fan. I like the style. I like the style.
It's fine.
Oh.
What's he got?
It's always fine.
It's always fine. We always got it.
Always ready.
So, song picks of the motherfucker week are done.
I thought we were going to go again. Are we getting a second round?
you want another song pick or what, motherfucker?
We can always do another one.
Now, we have some extras with the fake Eminem and a little Windex.
We did. So, make sure our boys got to get going over here is what you're telling me.
We're getting there. Give me a second
clean
here.
Your
give
windows.
Me a second
clean
here.
Clean it up.
I'm cleaning it up.
Talk about
I'm
something.
Oh, I mean, how you feel about that Windex video?
It was fun. I like the fake Eminem shit.
I think it's fun. Yeah, I think it's
fake
Eminem
shit.
It's very cool. Very fun.
Yeah, it's pretty hilarious.
If you were to make a fake persona, what kind of rapper would you be?
Like, make it fun of?
No, just to be a...
What would your fake rap name be?
Yeah, what would your fake rap name be?
I want dreadlocks of some sort, like braids.
That'd be tight. Mine would be Jared Sampson.
White dude. Steve Carell.
Jared Sampson. Coming to the stage.
Jared Sampson.
Coming out all smooth and shit, rapping Jared Sampson, then doing the foul shit on the mic.
Cameron Foster.
Oh, that would be tight one, too. That man's used this alias before, though. That's a good one.
Schmerich.
How about you?
Shamshin.
David Soto.
No.
David Soto.
Randell Lino.
Fuck it. Oh, that's a sick one.
That's a good one.
You're killing him if you're hitting him with that one.
Come out as Gabe Corral.
Lil Windex might be the best parody rapper currently.
Actually, I think the best name of all names to come out with would be...
Who?
Read my lips.
Who?
Dustin Stockdale.
Dustin Stockdale.
210 South Loma Drive. You hit him with one of those.
Hit him with that.
Dude, I always remember that address my whole life. 210 South Loma Drive.
And that right there is another podcast for another fucking Friday night. Thank you for joining us. If you're joining us on YouTube, thanks for checking us out. Go ahead and download the podcast on your podcast app. If you're listening to us, go ahead and subscribe on YouTube and watch the podcast because we do this shit live every other Friday. Thank you, Yamas, for coming out and doing your thing.
Thank you for having me.
Hey, thank you, Sick, for doing what you do.
Oh, you know it.
Hope you have fun at the Oscar Goldman Show. Show Fuck some yeah. Oscar love.
Oscar Loveman.
Oscar Steve, Goldman.
Steve, thank you for coming out. My boy, Real Wise.
Yeah, shouts out to Robert Friedman.
Hey, Woo! Shout out to fucking Scooter.
Leather jackets.
Shout out to Scooter. Hell yeah.
Yo, Robert, if you're there, I just want to let you know, I still got your leather jacket, motherfucker. You ain't got no goddamn leather jacket. And God didn't create this shit, but we did. We're going to continue to make your ass laugh every other Friday.
Yeah.
So stick with us or get left behind. This is your boy, The Infamous Nonsense, saying Merry Christmas. Oh, no, not even there yet, but we're getting there.
Merry Christmas and Happy Hanukkah.
You fucking motherfuckers.
Sick, thank you again for doing your thing. We appreciate you, bro.
For sure. Hey, look, people. Go get the Oscar Goldman album. That shit is fire as fuck.
It is a good album.
Go check out the self-titled Oscar Goldman album. Go check out Illogic's The Transition.
Dessert.
Go check out everybody's shit. And we will see you again in a few weeks. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. And as always, do not kill yourself, America, because we love you. Peace the fuck out.
Watch Jingle All the Way while you're at it. Hurting them.
Say goodnight, John.
Goodnight, John.
Goodnight, Jack.
Get the fuck out of here.
Goodnight, Jack.